There we go.
The freestyle by Corey Holcomb and this bitch. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Ever since I saw the little hoe, niggas knocking on my motherfucking door.
Is Trina there? Is she coming out?
I say, hey, put that thing in that bitch's mouth. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. Going in my refrigerator. Every nigga that nut in her, somehow they hate her.
Ow.
Her two kids that she kept cause she thought them dudes was gonna give her fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Cause it's your daughter. But get the daughter out my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
Oh, I told you he had some shit.
We on? Mm-hmm. All right, motherfucker. We was only 1 minute late this week, right?
Somebody ooh, said 2 minutes.
2 minutes. Fuck you, nigga. Who said that?
Yo.
Spell his name.
Yo, mom. Some.
Pseudo vitamin. Chris, motherfucker, be knowing these niggas. Chris be studying the chat room niggas and shit. Like, let this nigga say something else about it. Get blocked. Don't nobody be getting blocked, motherfuckers. That we on a hoe ass. You stream with some hoe ass internet. That's what somebody told me. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if the internet is the problem. But anyway, what up, America? I want to say, first of all, to my man Scoe Bubble in the hospital. God damn it. Get well, boy. I know you fucked up. That motherfucker checked in the hospital a month ago because his stomach was hurting.
A month?
A month ago.
Been in there a month?
Been in there a month.
Damn. His family?
Yeah, he got something going on.
Cause they would have kicked this.
Still working on him. Right. He ain't had something going on. They'd be like, all right, get the fuck out.
No, they can't do that.
They can't?
No, not in California. They don't do that.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You know for sure?
Yeah, but they'll be after you for that bill, though.
They'll be after for the bill. Go fuck that bill. Tell them motherfuckers to get you right. Go bubble. Right. Out there in Atlanta.
Oh, it's in Atlanta. Oh, yeah. They might throw him out.
Now, Go in there because something wrong with his stomach. A lot of motherfuckers in Atlanta be in there. Cause they got that package. They got a whole package wing for the hospital. All the boys got that.
Waiting for it to come out.
AIDS as I die slowly.
Wow. The package wing.
As I die slowly, you caught it free.
I caught that.
Jesus.
As I die slowly,
goddamn.
Yikes.
No, he ain't on that. We just go get better with your fucked up ass stomach. You know we love you, boy.
Stomach equals AIDS.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Jesus.
You got stomach AIDS. No, fuck it. Nigga ate the wrong
the wrong hypodermic needle.
This nigga ate a
you ate the
right.
Wrong needle.
This nigga ate a vegan bitch who fucked niggas in Atlanta nightclub. Anyway.
Let's
go get well, boy. This week, subbing in, we got my man. Some of y'all who loyal to the show know who that is. That's my man Freeze Love in the house. Freeze, what up?
Freeze!
Yo, man, thank you for having me back, man.
Freeze. Come on, man.
No, it's
that's
good.
That's the
like
homie
it.
Right there, y'all. Mm-hmm. Freeze.
I like being here.
Real nigga right here.
Yeah.
You know, Freeze. I like that. Say what's on your mind, shit.
Now, I'm one of the skinny niggas on the show. Now, I'm fucking with you.
Challenge!
That's my man right there, Freeze Love. So, how was your show Monday?
Nigga.
You said that show, I called you. What was it about?
It was crazy. It was called The Semen Cemetery.
What? Semen Cemetery, for all you ladies who like to swallow the seeds.
The sunflower seeds.
That was what it was about?
No, the title was based off of a scientific find out of Australia that says, women who let men bust in them raw. That semen lives on in them forever because semen can cross the blood barrier.
You crazy than a mother.
And then they said,
true.
Yeah, then they said, not only does the semen live in the woman, but the DNA information of past boyfriends influences and affects her offspring.
Mm.
Jeff Brown had a great joke.
So those porn women. What happens?
Any woman, though, ain't just.
Oh, yeah, but they don't use protection. Most of them, especially, they don't have to.
Listen, ladies, this is some real shit. If
they
you want to
get ejaculated on and in, and
if you want to get semen out of you, I want you to go and get some long ass eyelashes and put some of that eyelash glue and put it in your pussy because that shit pull everything off. These bitches out here looking like they on straight chemotherapy without Damn. Them eyelashes. These bitches the sacrifice looking a certain way. These hoes pull their whole eyelash off to take the shit off, man. Wow. And will tell you, you ain't no real man. Bitch, if you don't get your eyelashless ass, how the fuck is you a real woman and you ain't got no eyelashes?
Right.
They don't have
eyelashes. Winky. Winky.
Winky. Winky.
Eyelashes, eyebrows, everything. They going kind of far now with it.
I don't give a fuck if you got any type of illness you got. If you got a cold, put some right long now, ass eyelashes with some of that glue down your throat. You going to pull all the cold. You gonna see your cold on the eyelash. You throw it away. That eyelash glue is a motherfucker, dick.
How do you know? Just because you saw them pull
out? I done seen girls without their eyelashes on, and I be like, bitch, what is wrong with you? Man. Is that you?
It's Trinity. Right.
It's Trinity. Right. When them bitches take their eyelashes off, man, because they use some glue that's too strong, obviously.
Well, I've never seen that. Huh? I've never seen them use glue that's too strong. I know that they use it because flexible to come off. Good enough to hold it, but flexible to come off. I don't wear them because they mess with my eyes. In other words, it's good enough to keep them on. But it's just pliable enough so that it can pull it off.
Darlene, don't put on them eyelashes.
I don't need to.
You're probably using the correct one.
Right.
But then there's some knockoff ones. There's probably crazy glue. It's not you're supposed to go on your eye. But they got it down at the beauty supply. Oh, yeah, it's really good. Put it on. It takes everything.
$5.99.
$5.99.
No, what they do is they do have ones that last for a long time. In other words, you go to a salon and they have, my niece gets it done. They either sew them on or they glue them on and they last for like 2 weeks.
They going in on
freeze. Somebody say freeze the Mexican Cory Holcomb.
Freeze love bench presses front lawn.
What you say? Hey, whatever.
Hey, whatever, fucker. Hey, man, hold
up. Well, can you tell that I don't have any of my makeup on this week? I got
somebody
a cold.
Say Gorilla Zoe glue.
I got a bad cold. So I couldn't put any eye makeup on. Really.
So you saying, if what you're saying is true, Kanye.
Wow.
Wait, now.
Oh, damn.
Wait, are you going to try and say that his kid is mixed up with the other kid? With the other
if
guy?
What you said is true, Kanye dick is being dipped.
What? Being dipped in what, Corey?
Do I have to say it? Ray J. Ray J. Juice?
Wow.
Is it, who else you got?
Homeboy, what's the basketball player's name?
Oh, yeah, Chris Humphreys.
Chris Humphreys. Wow. Them the people Reggie y'all Bush. Just talking oh, about.
Reggie Bush. Here it is right here. Here it is right here.
Nick Cannon.
There you go. Nick Cannon.
Be careful who you sleep with. Study shows women carry the DNA of sexual partners. They got this woman looking like a zombie right here. Hugged up with this dude.
And this was fucked up about that shit. We coming to your segment, D, in a second.
No worries.
This was fucked up. Now, this is some real shit. If you like a motherfucker, you will still fuck with her. It don't stop shit. This motherfucker.
Don't stop nothing.
Who cares if we have calico kids?
Calico kids.
That explains Cheryl Underwood's gums.
Cheryl Underwood gums. Finally, Zoe going in.
Sorry.
Zoe finally going in. Yeah. We gonna tell Poetess you said something about somebody.
What happened?
Don't be on that show talking like Corey.
Flake.
Oh my god.
That bitch got more dandruff in her head than goddamn. This bitch. One day this bitch poured some frosted flakes in her hair after she stopped. Chris laughing. He know I'm right. You know when you laugh, that means you co-signed what I'm saying, right? On the streets when a motherfucker laugh, you be like, that means that's what you said. Yeah, what he said.
That's messed up. It could be a light form of psoriasis. I know a girl who has that.
What is psoriasis?
Very dry. It could happen on the scalp, but it could happen on their skin. And but when it happens on the scalp, one of my friends, I don't want to say her name because you will put her on, but she'll be mad at you. But anyway, so she has it, and it's bugging her out right now because it's all crusty right around in here. Really? And yeah, poor thing. Yeah,
she needs to put some coconut oil on it.
There you go. That might
coconut oil help?
Coconut oil.
Or does it hide it? Does it help it or hide it?
It I think it'll just it'll like both, grease it up just so at least she can like put a hat on and don't have to let it simmer.
But when you put coconut oil on your head, your head look like this.
But that's better than flaking everybody out.
That's
it's
true.
Better than looking like that's you true. Rubbed the ashtray on your head.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
That's fucked up.
Oh, damn.
Well, I don't give a fuck if it's psoriasis or motherfucking dendriasis.
Somebody. Dry scalp equals AIDS.
They're crazy. Dang, that is messed up.
So, would you fuck Porter?
Yes.
You would?
Mm-hmm.
See, I be knowing. Zoe got a type. Candy Bar Brown is the ideal type.
I knew you was going to say that.
Is a dude.
What? Bonus is a upstanding woman.
Yeah, all right, nigga. We're going to leave that shit alone.
Wow.
We're going to leave that shit alone. I remember Porters used to be telling motherfuckers in the chat room, don't say stuff like that. I was like, bitch, how you going to tell a nigga what to put on his computer?
Right. Do whatever
this
you
bitch
want
to control your computer at the crib. Hi, Porters. You look nice today.
Oh, yes.
And by the
retweet
way,
tweet that.
Candy Bar Brown was beautiful, too.
Hold on, Zoe. Let's get this on record. Zoe said what? Candy Bar Brown was beautiful.
She is beautiful.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Candy Bar Brown is
this
beautiful.
This was one day when you was on hiatus.
I don't know.
You go now, Corey's about to aggrandize the situation.
It go was ahead. A lady. We was talking shit to her when we had a phone line. She was talking shit about everybody.
She wasn't there in person.
But this bitch knew where to go. And the next week when we came in.
Why you leave out your part?
What don't let me forget nothing. What did I say?
You said, come up here. Because you was arguing with her on the phone.
This is how I know Zoe fucking Candy Because we told
I'm not
bitch,
fucking Candy Bar Brown.
We told the bitch to go. We told the bitch to go where you send bitches like that. To a taco stand.
And I was with
it
you.
Was a taco stand across the street.
We was at Okie Dog. Okie Dog.
Across the street. I ain't told this bitch nothing about coming to RMC. But the
you
bitch
didn't say. We got to pull up the video.
Pull up the video. The bitch was sitting there next week with a computer like she was part of the show.
What?
And I was like, who is that?
I didn't bring her.
And then she looked at Zoe like.
You said they weren't going to say
that. What the fuck?
That's you said it was cool, Zoe.
And then that's when you say, well, people say anything when you're in the moment.
That's what poet is.
No, when I got there. She was there, or she came shortly after I got there.
Y'all came up there together, nigga.
You always like, late, so you don't know who came first.
I know they was together. Zoe got up.
We wasn't together.
Zoe be online getting up with motherfuckers. He was like, you up here in Okie Dog? Because I'll come back up. And Zoe Okie her dog.
What the fuck? Candy Bar Brown's an upstanding, beautiful woman.
That bitch look like her sandal sweat. Look at that.
Slip and slide.
Right. Get your wet foot ass the fuck out of here.
Hey, she is a fan of the show.
Everybody,
this show.
Everybody's entitled to their own opinion. I'm not saying Candy Bar Brown is ugly. All I'm saying is, if you walking hand with hand with her, hand by hand with her.
Hand and paw with her.
Right, goddammit. You got to go
hand
straight
and
up.
Paw?
Hand and paw.
You're walking hand and paw with her. Who am I?
You got to go to all blues festivals. She a blues festival looking bitch. Like, if you with her at a blues festival, people be like, okay, that bitch can sing. You know what I'm saying? But if you with that bitch.
And probably play the bass.
Right.
Now she's a blues singer.
And a bass player.
That bitch look just like she. Hell yeah. I hear the booty boot.
I don't even know.
Zoe gonna build a motherfucking dance club like on Color Purple and shit. Zoe gonna be out there. He gonna build a juke joint for Candy Bar Brown. Fuck out of here, Zoe.
Jazz hands.
Get that gospel singing bitch the fuck up out of here. You gotta take that bitch.
Oh my God.
That's fucked up, man.
Bitch got all that bitch got a record player with jazz play with jazz instruments in that motherfucker.
Okay.
We're joking.
Jesus.
This is the time of the show where we go into a very important segment. It's called Loose Talk About Bullshit. Yes. Bullshit. Where Darlene brings the bullshit and we go in.
Here we go.
Yeah. All right.
What up, D? What's that?
And then excuse me in case I hope I don't forget and then all of a sudden I snort or something like that. But I've got a bunch of
you
crap
gonna snort.
In my throat.
You got mucus in your throat?
Yes, I do. I've got a little cold and
you know what that means.
Where did it come from?
What do you mean, where did it come from?
Where did the mucus come from?
I work at a couple of gyms. I'm around a lot of children. And I've got my hand sanitizer.
Damn, she ain't even got started yet. What they done zed
they
her
just
up?
Playing. They love that.
Antibacterial wipe.
Yeah, so that I don't give you, you know, every time I touch my face or something, I want to wipe my hands. And, you know.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
Trying to save us from your virus.
Yeah. I got a little cold. It happens. And I have lack of sleep. So I get, you know, I get a cold here and there.
Okay.
You just asked me how to get the cold. God dang it, Corey.
You
are Carrie Champion. You are Carrie Champion.
You are Carrie Champion.
You are Carrie Champion.
I'm over here snorting, covered with over here by poor Chris.
D, you are Carrie Champion with real hair and real eyebrow.
Damn.
At the end of the night, Carrie Champion will be, I'm tired of Stephen A. talking shit. I was in this bitch house, man. She had so many eyebrows on the floor, but I thought them was mosquitoes that was dead. I was like, God damn, bitch, all these damn mosquitoes.
No, but have you noticed lately?
What is wrong with this dude?
Have you noticed lately driving around the street? I don't know how many times you've seen it, but we've been keeping track now. We're driving down the street. We're like, oh my God, it's so scary looking. You just see hair. It's just all over the city.
Like it was a hell of a fight.
I don't know if they get tired of it. It's an old one, and they throw it out.
I'm ashamed.
It's just a bunch of hair everywhere.
I'm ashamed to say my sisters are stopping up stools all over the country.
You know what?
Is this a? Are we?
I'm gonna get a new one.
Boom! And then, you can't flush that. Oh my God!
You don't flush that shit down the toilet. Goddamn it!
They messing things up. I see in the street, toilet. And I'm like, I'm thinking, I'm slow down because I think it's an animal. You know what I'm saying? Anyway.
But it's not an ant. What is it?
Look like an ant revolution.
All right. So the first thing I wanted to talk about. Tumbleweaves. All right, y'all. Anybody
Tumbleweaves?
Anybody out there that has been married in one of the states, and California is one of them, that has the law where a spouse, meaning husband or a wife, can sue the person that their other spouse is messing around with and that they gave anything to. They have to prove it now.
This is a new law?
Yes.
Wow.
And it's been out there, but nobody's really taken advantage of it because they think they can't, you know, win or prove, and so they don't want to use their money because you have to use your own money.
They've been letting
the
rich people get away with it.
Well,
take advantage of it.
Well, no, now. The first person that I know that didn't really have too much money. Now, the other person had to have money. So the first person I heard this case, somebody win it, that was known, was Fantasia's dude that she messed around with, his wife.
Mm.
He was with his wife, and he messed around with Fantasia. That was a couple years ago.
Right.
And she had proof that she knew they were married. And so she waited, and then he left her, ended up going with Fantasia, had a baby, didn't marry Fantasia, but then he ended up going back to the wife, and she sued Fantasia.
And Fantasia couldn't read any of the paperwork.
You know what? I am good.
What did this say? Excuse me, could you read this for me?
You know what? Okay. Let me continue. Anyway.
Shut up, you big little bitch. You paid the hoe.
Go ahead.
Shut up. I love some Fantasia. I love Fantasia. You know what? Free yourself. So, anyway, I had to go. I had to say that. I couldn't help it. That's my favorite song.
Damn.
Anyway, here in California, this is one of the states.
Why I got to pee?
This is one of the states, and Shelley Sterling just won. But people think it's the first case against that woman, V. Stiviana, or whatever that is, because I don't know if it's a woman or man still. But she, right? Remember that girl, guy? I don't know.
Call her Jawline.
Howard Stern.
This V. Stiviana.
It's a woman. The homies be fucking that bitch.
Okay, well, she won against this one, but she also won another one previously, but people didn't hear about that one because it wasn't as big. But she ain't playing around, so Shelley won this case. Didn't get all the money that was given to her, but the majority of it. And now the girl doesn't have it, but she has to pay it back. She has to pay 2.1, but it was proven,
I thought it was 2.6.
Something like that.
Whatever
but,
it is.
Wait, though, but she got way more than that. Yeah, they said that she was given $3.6 million in gifts.
How is she going to pay that back?
And
Las Vegas and
hustle box.
Well, no, they have to sell the home, so they get the home back, the property. It's $1.8 million for the home. And a total of $400,000 in several cars put together. So she proved it, because what you have to do is you have to prove that you didn't know, and it's community property, and you gave someone else outside of the marriage something that the other spouse did not agree on. And they can do that. So they can sue.
So what you're saying is that hat that the bitch was wearing to cover her face,
the visor.
She need to get that motherfucker permanently sewn on her face. Cause that bitch was walking around with this hat to cover her face. It was a visor.
Okay, I remember. Yeah.
But the only problem, she has to give that hat back.
Oh, God.
You got to give that
this bitch
back.
Can't even hide no more. God,
yeah. So that's,
did he get her fake titties? Do you have to get fake titties back?
Cut your
How do you?
Whatever. If they can prove. If they can prove anything. So the thing is, they had to prove in court that certain things that she was given that Shelly didn't know of. Because the girl was saying, it, and also, she started this lawsuit before V. Stiviano supposedly leaked that tape. So apparently they were saying she thought, V. Stiviano thought she was going to start something or get back at the family by doing that. Hmm. Or else we wouldn't have known how he was, you know, the racist or what have you.
Well, that was her Trump card.
She thought, but she screwed it up. She screwed it up because look what ended up happening.
If what Darlene is saying is true, they're going to have get the titty back surgeries going on around the country. Bitches going to have to give up their titties they got from married motherfuckers.
Or whatever he gave
actually,
them.
So that means they need to keep all the shit they take out for a few years in case they get found out. They put the stinky juice back in. Because ain't nothing but dead juice in there once they're a certain age.
And they're gonna
all women over 35 got dead cell juice.
Right,
that's
say,
not titties. If you squeeze it and something come out.
God.
That shit not, the aliens so spit out will come out.
Yellowish, creamyish, yellowish, clearish.
Yeah, I've seen it before.
What the, you guys,
what?
Both of you guys, cut from the same cloth. All right.
Well,
Yep.
Dead juice.
That's true. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, okay, man. And then the next thing.
I know what you mean.
Somebody said dead juice.
All right, so the if you guys definitely have heard by now that Aaron Hernandez, you know how he was convicted. And when they announced that he was guilty, he looked over to the jury and he mouthed. He had an angry scowl on his face. I don't know if you saw it.
They say Zoe bitches age like milk.
What?
What? They age.
They say Zoe bitches age like milk.
What?
I don't even know.
Terrible.
What does that mean?
Quick, milk get old.
Yeah, quick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Anyway, so Aaron Hernandez was found guilty, and he looked over at the jury with an angry scowl, and he mouthed to them, "You're wrong." And he gave him a bad look, and he licked his lips, and he said that he's going to appeal. But the state said, I doubt that. The way that this person was murdered, they doubt that he's going to be granted an appeal.
Oh.
Because of how bad it was, like how
he got caught up.
How cold he was. And they called him when he walked out the court the $40 million murderer.
$40 million murderer. Should call him the $40 million dummy.
Exactly. Had it. Yeah. Can you imagine that? Throw it away.
But we all know people who are to the core. That's who they are. You know what I mean?
Well, you know, they said that they knew. They said.
Guess what?
Yeah.
Guess what? The people that I know that are to the core, they don't play football. That's what they do to the court.
Yeah, right.
Once you're playing football, nigga, how can you be out robbing niggas if you got to go to practice?
Okay, right.
That's
you
right. That's saying? Right.
Yeah.
Leave it alone, man. You was playing football. You
but once
there.
Again, but once again, the NFL.
That's right.
Again, the NFL still knew, and also go back to even the college knew how he was because he had problems even in high school.
No, they knew. They knew what kind of personality he was from the jump. They knew that.
Like they tried. They always know. And they knew.
But he could play. The motherfucker was good, too.
He basically said, look, we're going to get this guy. Give him our money.
He's not dark. We can advertise him. He's not Jameis Winston color.
Right.
No, we can advertise that with anybody. NFL, they'll take anybody. And look, come on.
Because he's a fucking
NFL,
idiot.
They'll do it with anybody. No. They just want to win.
That money back.
The darkies. They get it right back. The darkies get called out. Jameis Winston is probably, hands down, one of the best quarterbacks to come out of college
in a long time. Years. Yeah.
A guy you know he got it.
Yeah.
All you do is hear so-and-so, but will they take Jameis Winston? That's all you hear.
Yeah. And you see what's happening with him.
Yeah.
Well, the white girl has filed charges against him. And I knew that was going to happen once he got off to Florida State. You know, they did their little investigation, then
so
Florida.
So what happens? And what is a civil lawsuit, actually?
So now she filed because he's going into the NFL. That's where he gets his bread. So now she's going to file.
How do you win a civil lawsuit if you lost the got your pussy took lawsuit? Because everybody says she was a
totally
set out
different.
Piece for the whole
What lawsuit is it called again?
What is it now? He done came up with his own.
What? What did I say?
The got your pussy took lawsuit?
Yeah, yeah. Her got your pussy took lawsuit failed in court. She tried to destroy that young man.
This dude.
Because something happened when he put dick in her. Well, I don't know what it was, but when he put dick in her, it was people there saying the bitch was getting set out. And she felt funny. Something about, I bet Jameis Winston did that shit that he did on that table. Fuck her right in the pussy. You know what I mean?
Oh, my gosh.
Like the motherfucker on the internet. And that bitch got mad. Because the bitch can be getting set out. But if you say something, yeah, bitch, you like everybody fucking you, she'll be like, oh, you raped me. What?
Oh,
bitch, just because I said that?
Wow.
When you running a train on bitches, just be quiet and skeet. And get the fuck out of there.
Right. Keep a mask on. That's what you think Skeet they got skedaddle. Masks for.
That's what I'm
saying. They got masks for.
Oh.
When you fuck bitches with masks on, they act like they scared. Oh.
That's part of the deal. They understand that when they go in there.
What is going on?
What's happening?
Yo, I'm just keeping
it. Loose talk about bullshit.
I guess.
Some of those bitches need to wear masks, goddammit. That Candy Bar Brown elderly pussy, goddammit.
I've never fucked Candy Bar Brown.
Lying. You know that old bitch was like, ooh, so give it to me. Give it. You know that elderly sound? I'd have been there before.
Do it.
Give it to me.
Why you sound like a Bill Cosby?
Is that how I sound?
God damn. Give it to me.
That's old.
Young girls would be like, come on, motherfucker. Young bitches, they can't say, like, even if they try to say, come on, motherfucker. That's that elderly sound. When you get older, you slow down. Right. Right. Ooh.
Shit, dog.
Right. Ooh. Ooh. What's an old saying they say?
Look at you.
That's
look at you.
To get down. I said, what's an old saying? Dali know a lot of
them. Get down to get down.
I like a lot of them.
That dick groovy, baby.
Moving and groovy.
That's you went way back. Ooh, you went way back.
That dick is something else.
Ooh, something else.
Too much.
Child,
too
please.
Much. Too much.
Get some of this old ass truffle butter on your dick. Baby, that ain't truffle butter. That's
Big gay.
Truffle Big Gay.
Truffle Big Gay.
Oh, my face.
Oh, shit.
That's hurt my head.
What else?
Anyway, I don't know if you caught that ESPN reporter, Britt McHenry. Did I send you her picture? I don't know. She was getting on my nerves. Anyway,
Did I send it to you?
Oh, that's Bruce Jenner. Same I know.
Bitch.
Doesn't it look like a woman? I was going to go there next. Oh, maybe I didn't send it to you. All right, anyway, I didn't. Anyway, she had her car towed, and she went to retrieve her car, right? And when she got there, she started talking shit to the clerk. And the clerk was like, uh-oh. And she was like, oh, well, you know what? I'm on TV, bitch. Like, you know, and the girl was like, clerk was like, well, you better watch out because you're on camera right now, and I can always show that to you. Oh, I would sue you guys. And she went in on this woman, and they aired it. And then the ESPN's like, oh, my God, we're on it right away. She is suspended for a week. And I mean, this girl totally berated this woman, like dissed her.
Show a picture of the bitch.
Did I send it to you?
That bitch got to hustle that truffle butter to make that bill money for a week.
No, you, I don't know. You've probably seen her. She's on ESPN.
The truffle butter hustle.
Anyway, she, yeah, here she goes. Here's a good one.
Where's bitch at?
Right here. Let me send it to Chris. Anyway, so she was dissing the lady, talking about, you don't have, oh, I bet you if I didn't have an education, I would get hired from here. And honey, you're in a trailer, okay, I'm out here. And she was just going off and saying all this stuff. Of course, later on, she's like, oh, I'm so sorry. In the heat of the moment, you know, got the best of me. What? Bitch, no, that's your character, bitch. Let me see you out in the street.
Right. Now, Darlene turned up right
now.
Oh,
no, I don't like that. Don't be playing with no regular person trying to just do their job and get, did I send it to you?
Fuck them bitches and fuck her.
Here we go. Yeah, anyway.
Toyo Kai and this bitch calm.
And she's over here talking all this mess. It was so messed up. She's talking about her weight. She was going in on her teeth. And she just kept saying, yeah, if I didn't have an education, I can get this job. But I don't want it. You over here sitting in a trailer and just going off. So they played that. And they've been airing it. Oh, man. And then they said, oh, don't worry. We're right on it. She is suspended for a week. I couldn't believe that.
Suspended for a week?
Ooh, that's the video. Oh, and she just, oh, it just gets you, man. You just say like, oh, okay, girl, y'all, see
her.
Yeah.
Chris. We put this bitch up. If we ever do our show, we got to edit out the bitch.
Oh, whatever.
They say Chris been eating truffle butter.
No, Chris breath ain't, it don't smell like shit. It smell like,
what?
I'm just saying, you ever smell the rusty pipe they build the fence around?
Help.
Where it be real brown, you'd be like, oh, what the fuck is that? It's
iodine.
Right, it's
a sack of wet pennies.
Wet penny breath.
Copper. Some copper. Some
copper. Darlene going in.
Wait, copper mouth.
But I don't mean, I'm just going with that smell. I'm not talking about Chris.
Yeah, it's right. A copper mouth. It's copper. A new kind of snake.
Anyway, there was some other stuff, but I don't want to waste too much time, you know.
Don't let
it bite you. Anyway, don't so yeah, I guess that's enough. Oh, poor Bobby.
That's the bitch who checked the motherfucker.
Yeah.
But you can look at that bitch and tell she feel privileged.
Yeah,
like,
she thinks she all that. She's from Arlington, Virginia.
When you see bitches like that on TV, you already know. You be like, bitch, what are you here for?
Yeah. Man. Like that job holds any weight. Really? You're reading a prompter and you're holding a microphone. And?
You really got it twisted.
Well, no, they
any pretty girl can do that.
They'll have a bitch like that in the locker room. When men are getting dressed, and if a motherfucker be like, hey, look at this dick, though, he'll get in trouble.
Yeah, he'll get in trouble.
Wow.
Right.
Because I know if I'm in the locker room, and this is a motherfucker over there, I'm going, what's that look? You ever see a motherfucker run past and kick in
the street? What, streak? A photobomb naked?
What do they call that when you run past a motherfucker?
Streaking.
Streaking, yeah.
God damn it. Anyway, look at the hair on this motherfucking ass, bitch. What you doing in this goddamn locker
room? Don't say nothing. It's your job.
Right, bitch.
It's your job. Look at this.
Not my job to touch you, but it is my job to show me.
Anyway, that's it.
Baby, if you love me, I'll do anything for you.
I can see him singing in the locker room behind the goddamn reporter.
I'll be right behind that bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Funky slut. Bitch got them implants all in her butt. Your daughter ain't shit, bitch. Everybody know it.
Everybody.
In the locker room, this dick, I'm going to show it. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Bitch is funky. Look at this dick. Let me put it in your monkey. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
Oh, is that the remix?
That's the remix, goddamn.
Remix. One of these days, y'all gonna cut that motherfucker off. It's gonna be remixed in this motherfucker.
Anyway. Right.
Man, look, check this out. On a serious note, man, I was, I flew in from Chicago. I was at the airport. I want to tell all people who are black, brown, yellow, red. If you buy a last minute ticket on an airline,
what's going to happen?
There is a good chance racist Caucasian people will ask you about how you bought the ticket. Do you have drugs? Right. Do you have guns?
Wow.
This has happened to me about, real talk, no exaggeration, about 4 times at the airport. Today, I bought a last-minute ticket, and they was like, Corey Holcomb to the podium. And I was like, damn, motherfucker. It was already some motherfucker looking at me, right?
Right.
I'm trying
right.
to duck and get on the plane.
Yeah. Right.
And you know, on Southwest, because I had to buy Southwest, or I wouldn't have made it to the show. That was the only motherfucker had a flight that would have got me here on time.
Right.
So, you know, I paid for that little fuck-ass business select shit where it really ain't no special seat. It's just you get to get on first. It's a fuck you fair.
Right.
A fuck you fair.
A fuck you fair.
Gotcha.
Wait, a fuck you fair that you fell gotcha for.
Yeah.
We prefer to call it the gotcha fair.
We prefer gotcha. You sit your ass right next to the next motherfucker that paid $30 for that seat. You sucker motherfucker.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
And you get another bag of peanuts.
Gotcha. You get a drink ticket, you fuck.
Right.
You're going to have to be drunk to get through this shit. But anyway. So I'm getting ready to get on, and they call me over to the podium. I'm not knowing what's wrong. I'm like, damn, maybe they're going to give me a refund for this fuck
maybe
ticket.
Maybe an upgrade, even.
Right. Well, you can't upgrade on Southwest. God damn it. If they ain't going to let you sit next to the pilot, ain't shit else.
Damn.
Man, these white motherfuckers was like, are you Corey Holcomb? So how did you buy a last-minute ticket?
Wait, what?
How? They asked you how?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I said, are you serious? I said, I got money.
I have money.
And then the motherfucker said, do you have any drugs or weapons on you?
Wow.
I said, I went through the TSA security. What? They checked me for this already. But no, I don't. Then the motherfucker say, what do you do for a living? Now, this is why I always make white folks mad. This is why I was scared for my life. I ain't gonna lie. Because I said I sell baby clothes in front of abortion clinics. That's one of my jokes. God.
Yeah.
Oh, he was mad than the motherfucker when I said
you
that
said
shit.
This shit for real?
Oh, man, half the people saw the shit.
So somebody got it on tape.
He kept telling me to come over here. Like, let's talk to the side. I said, am I under arrest? He said, no. I said, well, I don't feel comfortable going over there. He said, why? What are you nervous for? I said, because you white with a gun. And I'm black. Y'all kill unarmed black people. You white.
No, anywhere in the world, y'all kill them.
I kept saying, you white. That's what really was making them mad. So they asked me again, do you have any drugs or weapons on you? And I was like, man, look, what do you want? You scaring me. Why are you doing this to me? If I'm not under arrest, because I had showed them my ID and everything. Yeah. I know how that go. You show them your ID, but they just wanted to go through my bags. He's like, is it all right if I go through your bag? I said, I don't want you going through my bag.
Again,
I don't
like
trust you.
Yeah.
He said, well, if you don't let us go through the bag, we're going to have to take your bag and compensate it, and then they'll just mail you your bag later on. And I was like, well, take the bag. What I'm going to do? I just want to get on the plane and go home. So when that bullshit didn't work, they started doing the bad cop, good cop. You know, with one motherfucker acting tough and the other motherfucker like, hey.
Would you like some hot chocolate?
Right. You okay,
like
buddy?
Don't you?
Now, here go the motherfucking most frustrating part of what happened. This bitch walked up. A black bitch.
Oh, yeah. You know it.
Uh-oh.
I think you funny, but you going to hell.
Did she work for the airlines?
No, just a black
just random?
Just walked
random
over.
Sister.
I say, these motherfuckers sister shaking me down, and this bitch talking crazy to me. So, an opportunity to pile it on.
Oh.
Damn.
Police officer like,
you funny, but you going to hell.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
He kept asking me, what do you do? And I wouldn't tell him.
I think that's a question for your mother, sir.
Right. I didn't go there. I ain't talking about his mom.
Yeah.
They got pistols.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to be doing nothing wrong.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to owe child support. Hey, Stephen A. I didn't do nothing wrong, and the police still fucked with me. But I knew what was happening because I see the police always questioning non-Caucasian people about where they're going and what they got in their bag in the airport.
Yeah, that's.
I have never seen a Caucasian man pulled over in the airport because this is where they get you, especially at LAX. They rob black people at LAX. I know plenty of black men who have had their cash taken off of them.
They really?
My shake weight.
You know what?
No, I'm serious. I'm getting on
stop.
They took shake your weight. Shake weight.
I'm trying to get healthy. I'm trying to do something.
You had a shake weight on the plane?
It was
shut
a fat
it
bitch. You get it on the plane.
What?
It was a fat bitch. She seen a shake weight, and she looked like, oh, hell no. You ain't leaving the fat club. I'm like, look, bitch, I'm fat, but I'm trying to handle my shit. Go get your own shake weight. She took my shake weight.
It was a fat bitch that took it.
Yes, it was a fat bitch that took it.
I want to say to white America.
Like she's going to use it.
What the fuck is going on?
I don't care how you think that this shit is equal out here. You are privileged. Your white skin gives you a pass through most bullshit. I have seen. I knew what was happening because I was in Vegas the other day. I saw them do this to this Indian man. He was shocked. You could tell he was embarrassed. He was. I was like, well, you know what I'm saying? I wanted to go over to the Indian man and tell him, look, this is what happened when you're not white in America.
Look like this. Oh, you definitely get checked.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh,
come here, Habibullah. Come here.
Because they don't know who you are.
Habibullah.
Akmar, come here.
They don't know what you are.
Man, my name is Paul. No, what's your real name?
Right. Mm-hmm. Now, this is one of the real Indian men they were shaking down. The motherfucker.
Oh, my God. What?
What they call him?
What was that?
Barbecue
pits, nigga. You got your money. Get your money up. I'll come get your pit cracking. Right. What are you talking about, baby?
Yeah. Even though that wasn't even all that funny. But look, what Ronan 70 said, you will never see that. Ronan said, I do not see white people pulled over. And my wife used to work at United. And she say, businessmen, white businessmen, always walk up and buy last minute first class tickets. Shit costs $1,500 last minute. And I have never seen the police pull over nobody Caucasian and say, how did you buy that last minute ticket? That motherfucker might as well say, nigga, what the fuck is you doing in this world to not be dead?
Wow.
Did you guys see
that? No, that's real.
Sorry that that happened to you, though, Corey. But you got on okay? What happened?
I mean, shit. I was on the plane. It was people walking up to me.
But you took
even
it back.
White people. Like, that was some bullshit right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The worst part was when this white lady was like, I'm sorry that happened. I know if you were white, it wouldn't have happened.
They know,
and
they
I wanted to be like, bitch, go sit your monkey
ass.
Oh,
God. She was, come on.
She was probably she
I want to know if I can help your people.
She right. Do it to you.
What can I do to help your cause?
Nothing.
Right, nothing. You can go the fuck away, bitch, or crack that pussy open.
Here hey, let me
Now, remember, you know, though.
Yo, here we go.
Now, remember.
Door knob where everybody go in the bathroom.
Oh,
now, damn. Now, remember.
I like your daughter, bitch.
That classic scene in Spike Lee's Malcolm X,
right.
Where Malcolm tells the white lady, no. You can't help.
She said, what can I do? What can I do, Malcolm X?
He said Mr. nothing.
X, what can I do to help your cause? He said, absolutely nothing.
Now,
suck your dick, Malcolm.
But I will say this. Later in Malcolm's life, he retracted that.
He got pussy out there when he went overseas.
Because he went over there and he saw white people worshiping Islam. And,
listen, man.
You know, his mind changed.
Did you say white people worshiped Islam?
Yeah.
Here we go.
No, I'm saying so. I said no, I know a lot of people don't know.
No, he saw people in Saudi Arabia that were white skin, blue eyes, blonde hair on pilgrimage, on Hajj. And he saw that and he was like, okay, maybe, you know, we were wrong, you know, no, in terms of the information that was being
it's
taught.
It's informants everywhere.
Wow. Is that the prayer?
That's
what they say, right?
Radio on right from the prayer room. And I count seven of them by the door.
Oh, so the whole time that they just
they watch him, motherfucker.
This Candyland, nigga. You can't go nowhere.
Candyland, nigga. You ain't gonna never get rid of
it. Oh, my God.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Oh, who's the guy that plays Annie in the next movie?
I can't.
What the
what?
Fuck?
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
What are you talking about? You got some haters, man.
No, it's good.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I like Corey singing. Corey's good. He's all right.
What?
You're singing.
Said, singing?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what's up. Who's the guy? Don't just fuck with me. What are we going to do, man? We got to take this break?
Yeah.
Don't take the break. Come into
sing
the little puss ass.
Sing his own out.
I can't think of no stupid shit to sing. What's the stupid ass song to sing going out?
What's your favorite record, man?
I don't have no favorite record.
What's your favorite record?
You was singing.
I know.
This
I always,
nigga was in the car singing the soundtrack last week. He was singing the soundtrack to
Lion King
with Geraldine.
Oh, that's a good one.
Claudine soundtrack.
The yeah. Claudine. Oh. That's what it was.
But I always like to fuck.
Here we go.
Asian women off. Everybody was kung fu fighting and. They be feeling like I'm being a racist.
Everybody
and shit.
Was kung fu fighting.
Right, but if I was as fast as lightning. What the fuck they be feeling like I'm discriminating, I paid for the pussy. Hey, look at 5150.
Wow.
Kung fu fighting.
As fast as lightning.
Hey, be singing.
There you go, darling.
Yes, infinite instruction. Close your fucking ear, cause these bitches be lying, man. I'm tired of that bullshit. Really not the one to act the fool with. Try to wife you, bitch, but all you want was cool with. Used to go to school with. You know I excel in class. Can do the math, English. Can you understand my language? Our chemistry is off. A suicide on that gym shit. Been horsing around. I pays attention, not to mention you slacking off. Caused my last detention. Marry the wrong chick. Can fuck your pension. Her loving can cause your lynching. Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I've been told
okay.
The world outside is so, so cold.
Listen, who knew that I would be kicked out on the streets? Obviously, I did. My reality now is just what I perceived back then. So let's go, let's start on the future, cause this life is so cold. A positive mindset is crucial. Okay. Even though I'm walking on icebergs with no shoes on, if I put in the universe what I want back, I can't go wrong. Life is a game of ping pong, going back and forth through good and bad and through the bad time. You pussy niggas will bleed out, so grab a pad. With negativity, I'ma grab the ball and start putting. Cause for too long I've attracted what I don't want, like pain and misery. But those things no longer have meaning to me. Now my thoughts go a little something like this: longevity and prosperity, success, money, all the knowledge, all those bad thoughts. I have to stop it, yeah, out the picture. I cropped it, that's just a fraction, man, of the law of attraction. Fam.
I don't know, but I've been told the world outside is so, so cold.
So tragic. Wow. My sister called and said my fucking cousin just got blasted. Shot him in the face, no open casket, straight insanity. Damn. Didn't know him too well, but thought he was still my family. Okay. So deep in the struggle, fingers numb from trying to crawl out. Wow. So deep down in darkness, you barely hear me when I call out. Okay. Need buckling from this load, I swear I'm about to fall out. Wow. So tired out this cold world, I can't wait for it to thaw out. Okay. They robbing.
Little south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, you
motherfucking cat, oh, yeah. Motherfucking cat. I'm happy, this been a long time, man. I'm ready. Hey,
yeah.
It's your boy Juice in this motherfucker. Hey. I'm with my nigga T.E. to the motherfucking C. Y'all heard him. Hey. He talking on this beat, though. Hey. I'ma talk with these words. Alright. Shout out this motherfucker. Hey, Mr. Juice. Hey. John Point, motherfucker, DuSable. Hey. Shady 80s in this motherfucker. Wow.
Oh, the verse about to come up.
Southside, nigga. Hey. Yeah. Yeah. I step up in this bitch limping, big pimping, clutching the game like stick shift, shift shit. Move in front of the game. I'm from the place of JD's Vice Lords, they all my peoples. He get drawn on niggas like they was easy. Niggas would think you was water, they leave you see.
What?
Niggas keep more red dots than the measles. And a lot of niggas try to hate, I just say why hate. And try to keep my mind stay ill like my state. You won't see no more birthdays fucking with my cake. Get it straight. Afloat in the mist, I get.
fashion. Yeah. Fuck these other places with they weak ass fashion. Take it back, 150 hats, cartoon towel jackets. And we pop color rhymestones. Just imagine niggas saying, what the business, Joe? Shot pimp accents and act like you have since a field of pain. I've been popping since Common had since at the end of his name. And back in 97, you would get your head bust if you wasn't bumping adrenaline rush, nigga. Yeah. Hey, that's just some real shit from a nigga come from.
Duval. Yes, sir.
J. Bill, the city where I live, niggas shoot, rob, kill for the money for a meal. Sling weed, rock pill, caulking dope for the bills. How I really feel, you gotta get it how you live. How a nigga with no job supposed to make his paper? The crackers made the system for a nigga cause they hate us. But you don't see it cause your eyes stay closed. Mine stay open but them bitches stay low. Life is what you make it, tired of waiting, being patient, tired of.
Puerto Rican, baby.
From Cash Money.
Well, fuck you, nigga. Some pussy motherfuckers say corny going to McDonald's.
What?
This is a good combo. Fuck you, nigga.
Oh. It's on.
You back, nigga?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm doing? 5150 stolen my house. Darlene be having treats.
Was what we eating?
Some bark thins.
Bark thins is dark chocolate with almonds and sea salt.
Shit good. Some shit I'd have never bought. I bought the Snicker.
Is it good for you, though?
It's not bad. It's got not antioxidants bad. In it. Yeah, it's extra dark chocolate. Yeah.
So a nigga could get healthy with a bag of those.
Well, no, not necessarily healthy. Well, no. Then,
examine your shit, ladies and gentlemen. I want you to go through the stool and realize that's what was in you. It's not the end of the world. Go through your shit and feel something and see what you could find. Carrots are easy to find. Don't claim carrots.
And corn. Carrots.
This is what you do, huh?
And black olives.
You've done this before, haven't you?
Man, I got free time. And on top of that, if remember, I used to, we had a show where we talked about cleaning your ass, Twizzler.
See? And he found the garage. He found the little pocket.
Right. I get
the garage.
You remember?
What do we call it?
It was the ball closet.
Ball closet. That little thing in the back that you push your balls in.
Look at Freeze.
Ball closet. The ball closet.
Look at Freeze.
He's nigga, talking about there's a little the dip back
closet.
There between.
Yeah, this niggas never used a ball closet.
The hideout.
The hideout.
Get out the way.
It's parts of your body you need to explore and find, except don't use tools to find it. Use your humanly tools.
What is that?
Use your wash
like some motherfucker, right. Some niggas find their G-spot with little toys and
oh
shit.
Oh, my God.
They be like, man, I see what them fags be on, man.
Shush. Oh,
it ain't gay if I do it, man. This is my G-spot. I'm a real nigga.
Oh, my God. That's
not niggas don't have G-spots.
What's that nigga's
name? No, yeah.
What's the little rapper from
might
Canada?
Have a little sensitive.
Drake be like, nigga, this is my G-spot, nigga.
Oh, my God.
This is my truffle bug. Fuck is nasty if it's mine.
Damn.
Somebody said ball cave.
Ball cave. Ball
so you're saying just compartment. Explore yourself, explore your body. And
what
it's
have you
right.
found that you're proud of?
That I'm proud of? What have I found?
Right.
What have you found on yourself
right.
that you're proud
everybody
of?
Everybody be ashamed to talk
what
about
what
they do.
What kind of question is that?
Hey, look, let me tell you something I do. When I know I got a fart, I love to bend over because it feel better for some reason when you bend over and you fart because it blow out
clear.
Your ass clearer.
Right.
Is
so
that
you don't
what's
have,
happening?
Well, because you know
it's coming out clearer?
Well, you know the butt cheeks make the sound. It's not the actual fart itself. It's air coming. So it makes it. It goes, you know, it goes through.
So
our resident fartaholic. Fartologist.
Let me about this motherfucker. That's a fart sound. That's what? Your gas saying, let me about this motherfucker.
Freedom! It's true.
Right, freedom!
Freedom!
Right. Mm-hmm. Give us free! That's a fart. That's a but when you bend over and fart, It's easier. And it like it blow out better. It's like if you don't want
to. What?
Or you just prop it open a little bit.
If you don't want nobody to blow your ass, bend over and you can blow your own ass. That's all I'm saying.
This shit is going crazy.
What's some tight pants or a plastic pamper?
But both of us, wait, Corey, but wait.
He said send it to a summer.
Wow.
Wait.
Those beans with mighty power.
Shut up. Now, both of us had English bulldogs and their butts flat in the backs.
So wow.
Every time they'd fart, it would just, you just hear the. It's just air because there's no cheeks. There's no
silent killers.
Yeah.
My dog be on the couch and he never stopped doing this when he farted, you know.
Huh? Panting, he's panting. Mm-hmm.
I'm like, damn, how the fuck do you fart and let the shit out your mouth? All your body air leave.
This shit is stupid.
Right. This thing ain't got no body air. Wow. You need body air, goddammit. What is the gas good for? Is it not good for nothing inside you?
What
nowadays?
Is it good
for?
No, that's why it's releasing. No, it's just bubbles. It's air.
It's bubbles? I think it's methane.
Methane.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is.
Yeah, it moves around.
Why is it? What is methane, first of all?
That shit is flammable.
Yeah,
that's why you need to light it.
It's killing the ozone because so many cows. See, cows fart. Yeah. And all these cows farting at the same time, plus humans farting and all these other animals that fart.
But theirs don't smell. You know that.
Fucking up the ozone. That's how come they want to limit beef.
But theirs doesn't smell. Right. Theirs doesn't smell because they only eat.
Cows' farts don't stink.
It smells like hay.
I grew up out in the country. You know why? Because they don't eat meat.
You've heard a cow fart.
A lot of animals that don't eat meat, if they fart, it won't smell. It just smells like a.
You're standing next to a cow.
Of course, we have to understand this is
strong grass.
This is Darlene's opinion that cows fart don't stink.
Right.
That's my opinion. She's still back there.
No, most animals.
I said right now the helmet don't stink.
Right.
Don't smell this barn, man.
It all depends on what you eat.
Because manure.
Grass is a motherfucker.
Because manure stinks. Yeah. So it stands to reason.
Manure stinks.
That the farts.
Mm-hmm.
Which is the gas off of the air.
They say Darlene said cow farts don't stink.
No, it's not as bad as like somebody like ourselves that eats all that meat. I'm telling you, that's
you saying because the cow is a vegetarian that his shit stink less.
And rhinos and a lot of other ones. I've been.
I was fucking a vegan bitch.
Here we go. No,
and
seriously,
the bitch
I've been
shitted one day,
and it does not smell
I say,
as
bitch,
bad.
You might as well eat a gyro with that shit smelling like that. That bitch had gyro meat shit smell coming out that vegan ass bathroom.
Well, you don't know what else she was eating.
That's not just pineapples, bitch.
That's just not hummus.
The fuck? Well, it is. But.
Gross.
Somebody say Bobby on a secret date with Jamie Foxx.
Oh.
Jamie, shut up and get it over with. Give me that money for this cake and water.
Oh God!
You bought a machine.
Now all those people in the chat room that are saying no, I don't believe it. They're gonna go and start smelling some cow's ass. That's funny.
Gyro meat.
Good, they fell for it. Yeah.
Shut the fuck up with this fake science.
I have done tests on cow farts and I have the proof.
Right, exactly.
Smell.
Go knock yourself out.
Right.
Exactly. Exactly.
Oh,
yeah.
Hey.
Who cares if it does or it doesn't? People need to get a life.
Well, shit. I mean, come on. You said it doesn't stink. We
as bad. That's what I said. As bad. Well, go and investigate if that's what's so serious to you.
That's a profession. I am a fart analyst.
I say, Darlene, whole cow farts like bong hits.
Oh, I don't. I actually don't.
Wow.
No, that's, I don't hold them.
Oh, my
I
God.
Once cleared a Costco aisle. I'm not that proud of it. It was quite embarrassing, but
whatever.
I did. I once cleared a Costco aisle.
You farted in Costco?
I do all the time. Mexican. Yeah, sure. It just happens. Yeah, I eat a lot
Darlene
of beans.
Eat meat.
I eat a lot of beans. There's no
meat.
Shame I am.
And she work out. So the food inside her body is shook up and sweaty.
Oh, my. It don't sweat
it's
inside.
It's got to go somewhere. I can't leave it inside of me.
You do sweat inside.
It's got to go somewhere.
Darlene said you don't sweat inside. How you know? You ain't never been inside.
Oh. Yeah, you either. What, you been inside, Dr. Holcomb?
But we as men, we get closer to the inside. It gotta go somewhere.
You get close.
One day I was fucking this girl and I felt sweat in her pussy.
What?
Her pussy was sweaty. I thought her pussy was wet, but on the this sweat.
Oh, you just determined that.
How did you differentiate?
I knew it was sweat because we was fucking with the L on, and after a while it started hurting me.
What?
No. What? Hurt your nose?
Air conditioner dried her pussy out. That's sweat. When it's real pussy gel, it don't dry out. You can have the L on. You can fucking L.
Pussy gel?
Yeah, the gel.
Juices, you know.
Some girls have gel. Some girls have yeast and say, I'm coming.
You be like,
bitch, get your yeasty ass out of here, bitch.
What is going on?
Eat some yogurt.
All right. Get your Krispy Kreme coochie having ass and fuck on about it, bitch. Damn. You ain't coming, bitch. That's that yeast release.
Here we go.
Loosen your jeans up.
Anyway.
Bitch got a yeast infection from
your crotch area is too tight.
That's what they say. They be like, oh, my jeans were too tight. That ain't what happened, bitch.
So we're all human. So we've all just determined that. We've all come to the conclusion that we are all human in here, huh?
Yeah, we all human. So, what's the fucking...
Yeah, we got to do the topic. Goddamn,
man. We fucking did an hour before we got to the
topic. All right, so the topic. This is a good topic. The influence of music on black folks, especially the youth. Does the behavior of the youth come from listening to today's music? And is the music really giving those kids a code of ethics?
If you think about how black people would go to the disco back in the day and listen to Donna Summers, the music had you leaving there feeling to love somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Last chance.
Yeah.
Last
happy.
Chance,
feeling good. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, the music that's out is a lot truer and blunt because of the times. Like, I really think if Jesus really knew all the women at the average Baptist choir, if he sung a song, it'd be, little stupid ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you.
Jesus is singing?
Because he'd be speaking to them bitches.
Or he'd be singing, these hoes ain't loyal.
Right.
These hoes ain't loyal. For everybody.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Social game rules do come from music. And somebody called me today and was asking me about tones and do tones have hypnotic kind of induction when they put in the music. Now, I'm going to tell you like this. Back in the day, like you were saying, Marvin Gaye. Marvin Gaye's classic I Want to Fuck You record.
What is it?
Let's Get It On. Mm-hmm. Right? Sanctified Lady. You know, he had a couple records that was like, let's get
I
it on.
I
want
to say this, man, about Marvin Gaye. Accept him, so he said he Marvin Gaye, just like a foxhole.
Oh, my God.
This nigga. Listen, the fuck?
I don't know.
Social game rules, man. We learned how to talk to girls by listening to those kind of records. Marvin Gaye, The Spinners, Gap Band, you know, all of those records from back in the day, Shalimar, all those type records, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Prince, Michael Jackson, we learned.
Don't forget Special K, excuse me, miss. No, I ain't having it.
Right? Right?
He was, excuse me, miss.
Right?
What your man got to do with me?
Okay.
Right?
Right? But this is where we learn the social game rules. Now, where back in the days it was more smooth, it was more subtle, it was more cool. Now, like you said, it's in your face. Clap that ass, bitch.
But we had that too.
Yeah, we have.
That degree.
No.
What back in the day was that?
Luke.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, she got some good pussy. Remember that?
Yeah.
And you see what happened?
Yeah.
He was banned.
He opened the door, though.
He was banned. They banned him.
They banned him. But listen.
But he fought and came back. He got the band lifted.
He took it to court and won.
Right.
That's how Uncle Luke was saying. He took it to court and won.
But Luke gave Viacom, BET/, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Viacom, they bought the company off the nigga who used to have shows like Teen Summit and and Old Girl Bev on there, all that positive black shit, that's gone. That's not part of the agenda no more.
Really?
Now it's all bullshit shows with bitches arguing and music that, in my opinion, makes it easy for somebody like a Drake, somebody like a Eminem, to come in and stand out. Because you're not, our best is not being displayed on Viacom, BET. The best rappers who rap from the soul and got something to say. What's your guy named? Cool Moe Dee?
Moe Dee.
Yeah.
They would never let a KRS-One, a Cool Moe Dee start. I remember when the Lynch Mob
or Talib Kweli, none of them.
Talib Kweli,
yeah, none of those.
They are not on the agenda of Viacom. Mm-hmm.
You know, it's funny you say.
But why?
Just the other day, I was reading this article. Somebody wrote on Facebook. This dude was saying he was a music exec in the early '80s. He worked for one of the big labels. He said he went to a meeting. And as soon as he got there, he had to sign a
non-disclosure.
Non-disclosure. He said if you don't sign it, you have to leave. Mm-hmm. Since some people left, he said he stayed out of curiosity. He said he went in there, and basically they said, "Listen, man, all of these companies, we have private interests in private prisons. We have investments in the prison industry. We need music to fill up these prisons. That's what we're looking for." Now, I started as a rapper in the mid-80s. 87, I signed my first deal. Everything was like, yo,
Black Profile Eye, Records.
Profile Records. They signed us. Poor Righteous Teachers. These were the groups that was out there. Public Enemy. Everybody was on the positive. We all in the same gang. Mm-hmm. What else was out?
Self-destruction.
Mm-hmm. Self-destruction. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? This was making
took a brother's life with a knife in his wife. Right. Cried because he died with a trifling death when he left. His very left. Breath. Exactly. Slips. Watch. Step.
Oh,
you remember that? Hey, motherfuckers, I was a Kool Moe Dee fan.
I know.
So you understand.
I still am.
And KRS-One, all of that.
Big Daddy Kane.
Philosophy on the industry. Don't bother dissing me.
Back in the day, our brothers and sisters would hang.
How could you gangbang?
What?
I never ever ran with the Ku Klux Klan.
But shouldn't have to run from a black man. Because that's...
There's no music like that. If you come in with a tape like that, they'll be like, get the fuck out of here.
Beat it.
Where's Lil Wayne?
But again,
or you have to sneak it in.
You guys remember it? There was a famous book out a little while ago, maybe 10, 15 years ago. It was called Conversations with God, right? Very popular book, number one bestseller. In the book, the dude said very simply, you can tell the level of a society's intelligence by what they're entertained by. So when you look at us today and you see that the music is dumbed down, the television is dumbed down, the movies are done. Back in the days, new movies were great.
Niggas just old.
Who said that?
Stereotyping.
Fuck you and your mom. Oh, I'm sorry.
You better believe it, nigga.
We are old, but I'm here to tell you. When I was in high school and gangbangers or whatever went down with something bad happened, the reaction was different. When I was in high school, you couldn't sit back while a girl was getting beat up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. What happened.
Now, all you new motherfuckers who say we old, it'd be a dude fighting a girl.
You see that video?
Right.
Punk. Whoa, stop!
Yeah. You see that?
You've been trained to lose, homie. Because even if the girl is out of bounds, when you see a guy fighting a girl,
right?
Right.
I'm not the one who's quick to always say the girl is right. But what I'm saying is, just like it's cowardly to shoot a motherfucker in the back,
right?
Right.
The cop that got granted permission to go to the Bahamas, by the way. Just like it's cowardly to shoot a girl in the back, it's also cowardly, in my opinion, for people to sit around with video cameras and videotape
doing something, right?
Women fighting or a guy kids, fighting everything. A woman. Yeah.
Yeah. Did y'all see that latest video that just came out where there's three boys jumping a girl, and I mean kicking her in the face, bombing on her, picked her up, scooped her, just really mashing her out because they were trying to steal her phone.
Bum ass niggas, man.
Do you understand?
Bum ass dudes.
No, I mean like not slapping her, not pushing
not
her, not grabbing and snatch and run. I mean literally going as hard as they can. I mean, it's on YouTube somewhere. That somebody tagged me and you and Claudia Jordan on Instagram in this video. It was like, Zo, watch this bullshit. Then I got it on Facebook. Then I got it on Twitter. And I'm saying, damn.
What is it coming to? Yeah.
These niggas went in on her like she wasn't shit. Like she was a dude.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, that's why I was so happy that person said we just old. Yeah. It's a... We are deteriorating.
Right. I want you as to be race. Old one day. Mm-hmm. And I want you to be old one day. I hope you
might not make it. Right.
At first off, we're not old.
I'm not.
We're older. We're wiser. Mm-hmm. And the difference between the young motherfuckers now versus the young motherfuckers back in the day is that the young motherfuckers back in the day respected the older brothers because we understood they knew something more about the game than we did in that moment.
Go ahead.
No, they're just quick to throw ageism like it's a diss. Boy, you better hope that you live as long and as well as
the point I was trying to make with it all is this. It's not getting better amongst us. Right. It's getting
worse.
Oh, yeah.
Worse. Mm-hmm. We will kill each other and use these devices as a way to laugh at it.
Right.
You're not recording it because you're trying to
help.
Oh,
or, yeah.
This is fucked up. You're like, world star. You have been programmed to destroy not only yourself, your brothers and sisters.
Yeah,
that's
help bring
you.
It down.
So
you're
when you say older, yeah, we're that generation. We're the last generation, in my opinion, before they have made their push to justify slaughtering us off.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's coming to that.
Oh, yeah.
It's coming to that because if you're paying attention to what's happening in the news right now, if you're paying attention, there's no way the police force across the country could be this dumb or this airbrained. This blatant shit happening because I believe they want to prompt some type of martial law.
Look, Zoe, I want to read this. Go down. Because this it was somebody said about our generation, what we did. Go down a little more. He says, stop.
Your generation.
Based Milo says, your generation built nothing and left us nothing. Y'all were killing each other in mass.
And smoking crack.
Now, I don't know who that is, but that is one will point the finger and talk about all the destruction somebody else did.
Right.
But I don't see him saying nothing about what he did because I have never killed anybody and I don't smoke crack and have you ever smoked crack?
I'm just saying I see what he's trying to
What is he trying to say?
I'm gonna tell you something
because this generation pop pills and they don't like the way they mama look and they marry bitches that look the opposite of they mama. Now I could say that but I haven't.
Well, you did. You just said it.
Hold on. I'm from the generation that you say smoke crack killing. Hey, guess what? That is why we are telling you. Because we're from a generation that was severely happening. I'm telling you, in the 80s, come on, man. In 1987, when I got out the Army, Cass was putting money in my hands. It was that.
It was like New Jack City.
Yep, it was New Jack. It was on. It was popping. Dudes that I used to ride the bus with was in Testarossa's.
The Testarossa.
They was in 9/11 slant. No, it was like, yo, what is this? What the hell is this?
I lived all that shit. But you could not fuck with the elderly. I mean, you couldn't fuck with the women.
No.
And you couldn't fuck with the kids.
You definitely couldn't.
On Worldstar, I seen a bitch beat up a bitch while she was walking with her baby.
A baby.
Yeah, we never seen no shit like that.
That's what I'm saying.
That kind of shit.
And hold on. The bitch hit the baby.
Yeah, I saw that. Well, let's take.
I was growing up, the whole motherfucking neighborhood would have stomped that bitch. Y'all like, what the fuck is wrong with you hitting that baby? Mm-hmm.
And this is, goes back to the code of ethics aspect of this conversation. First off, to what the brother said, there is some, there's a kernel, a modicum of truth in what he's saying. Yeah, we come from the crack generation. Yeah, but before that, it was the heroin generation. Mm-hmm. And now in your generation, it's lean. It's ecstasy. It's all types of shit. It's shit. You understand what I'm saying? It's a lot of way worse shit out there. But my question is, if we didn't build anything and you know it, now if you know what our mistake was, now you know what not to do. Mm-hmm. So what are you going to do to build some shit today? If you're saying y'all niggas didn't leave us nothing, y'all niggas smoked crack and was on crack. Now that you know what our mistake was, can you now utilize that as a blueprint for what not to do if you're articulate enough to bring it up like that?
They cannot use it easily for a blueprint because what they have been taught to do is not be accountable for nothing. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Wow.
To be dumb. It's been a massive dumb down. I can remember when I was a kid, cartoons made sense. They was talking, big words. Ether, what the fuck is ether? Oh, ether is some shit, if you inhale it, you'll be like floating. Like, you know, you saw shit in cartoon to make you get a dictionary. Say, what was they? You know what I mean? Yeah. It was, the whole level of conversation was bigger.
More the Bill Cosby had cartoon was very educational.
Yeah. Which one? Because he had a few of them.
I'm talking about the one with the gang. Bill Cosby.
Yeah, oh, Fat Albert. That shit had a message in every fucking episode.
Morals, all kind of shit.
Right. Now what Rudy did was wrong.
Right.
you learn some shit.
Right. But wait a minute.
Dumb Donald.
I'm a cumber, you be ain't.
They had the Ebonics. They represented it. But they like, listen, Roy. Cool, care, whatever.
Oh, memory lane ass niggas.
Hey, it's a good memory.
And you know what? I like that. I like that because we saying that Fat because up. I see a difference.
Wait,
Chris.
That nigga
said,
right now.
Fat Albert had.
Getting gypped.
He said, Fat Albert had type 2 diabetes.
I get that. I love it. But the point I'm trying to make is this, man.
Generation gypped.
Yeah, your generation is getting gypped.
If your daughter get jumped at school by a boy, it's not even the same thing as when your daughter get jumped at school by a boy back in the day. Because back in the day, if a parent saw a boy jumping on a girl, what do you think would happen?
Mm-hmm. He would, the boy would have caught him.
He'd be like, that's a crazy family.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know what I mean? They would just say the boy. Yeah. Man, whose son is that?
Who raised that monster? Yeah. Right. I got called that when I was.
I don't want to talk to him, but see, these nowadays, they don't even know who lives across the hall. They don't know who lives next door. You don't know you don't even know who lives.
Till you get into it with them, until you want to get high with them.
Right. And if you get high with them, at least you're meeting them.
Right.
Get high, smoke some trees with a nigga.
Meet them motherfuckers ain't smoking trees. Nah, no, motherfuckers be look at that old weed ass square ass nigga. You smoke that weed all you want, nigga.
Wow. That's what they do now.
My high right here, this little M&M shaped pill.
And see what
hey,
you don't
rip your eyebrows out and come give me some pussy.
Rip your
right. And some of you niggas are going to get stuck over there, too. You're going to be stuck. You're going to be stuck stupid.
Mm-hmm.
Them pills don't give weed. We, you will calm down.
Is there something we can pass down to the young brother who said we left nothing? Is there something we could pass them down right now?
But this is my opinion of somebody who has no accountability in what they say. I mean, like, we all fuck up.
Right.
How many people do you know talk about when they fuck up, though?
Mm-hmm.
I don't see a lot of people.
Accountability is difficult.
You know what, man? I fucked up when I did this.
Mm-hmm.
When somebody talk about what they do, it changes everything. But when you only talk about what somebody else do, you bitch made. That's what I call you.
Mm-hmm. That's
you
real.
Bitch made. Yeah. So, as you say, y'all niggas left nothing. You know what I'm saying? Be like, who are you talking to? Mm. That's my point.
Yeah. But I think as a people, I think this show is a platform. We got to create a bridge that the lost, what'd you call them? The children of what? Lost? The offspring of lost.
Club bitches.
Right. I think we got to use this platform as a bridge so they can cross over and at least get something from it that'll fortify them so he won't, or kids like that won't say, we didn't build nothing or we didn't leave nothing.
Let me tell you something. That's absolutely right, Zoe. Mm-hmm. But when was the last time you was at the club? I'm talking about the young nigga club. When the last time you was there?
I've gone.
When the last time you was there, D?
2 weeks ago, and I could not.
Fuck was you doing in there, D?
Fucking them little young niggas.
Oh, shit.
That's how she got a cold.
That's how she got a cold.
That has nothing to do with it. I go when it's somebody's birthday or something like that. I don't go. I can't stand it. You know me. I'm a dancer, so I like that. You can't dance to that bullshit. And then I see these girls, the songs come on, and I go, is she listening to what these lyrics are saying? And they're like, yeah, and they're just doing all this.
Shake
and I'm like,
that asshole.
No, bitch, they're calling them this and that. And they're dancing to these songs, and they're like saying all this dirty, nasty. The song is dissing them while they're like praising it. They're like dancing to the song. And I left. I just went, said hi, happy birthday. And me and Anoush Dan, they're going, oh, my God, this is it. Every song sounded the same, and it was repetitive. There was nothing.
I'll be in the club with the little motherfuckers when they pay me to come make appearances. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I'm here to tell you, I'm not one to criticize without having a sense of compassion, because these are our little brothers and sisters in here. But I'm here to tell you, these motherfuckers are reckless minded. Mm. They fight, and it's not, I'm talking about like, man, one day I was in the club, man, I'm talking about back in the day, my day, whatever they want to call it. And this motherfucker pulled out a gun in the club, man. And it was so funny because the people who, you know, he had this big ass gun out. The security was grabbing him at first, like, hold on, man, you're doing too much. He pulled this big ass gun out. The security guard was banging up. But everybody who didn't see the gun was behind him was there. This nigga had that big ass 45.
And a Dirty Harry.
Man, this is what I'm saying, man. This is why I bring that up. It shook everybody who saw it. Right. Not like scared. Like, man, that nigga was on bullshit. Mm-hmm. Umped that gun. He know he was drunk. You know what I'm saying? He was talking shit to motherfuckers. Woo, woo, woo. This is my opinion of what I see nowadays. The nigga with the gun who pulled it out and jeopardized everybody's life.
Right.
That's that nigga right there. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
He gets glorified rather than, hey, man, don't pull out the gun and motherfucking risk the lives of every motherfucker in there.
Right, because they're going to stomp each other.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What the fuck is you doing, nigga? This is our club.
Mm-hmm.
We go to this club every week. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Calm the fuck down. I'm talking about the OG niggas who holler at you.
Mm-hmm.
Do that whole shit, nigga. Don't do that. This is our shit over here. Now, ain't nobody claiming shit. Ain't nobody got no motherfucking sense of, hold on, I got to motherfucker stop these two bitches from fighting over here.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I got to stop. This bitch got her daughter with her and this other bitch fighting her.
And then go hit the baby.
Right. I'm saying, like, we all hate each other now. And trust me, the music that has been allowed to be played on Viacom station has something to do with it.
Now, people don't understand the power of music.
Well,
they don't understand it's hypnotic. I was in the industry.
Don't you have a choice? You choose what you want to listen to when you feel the same way.
Not necessarily. Not when somebody is spending a hell of a lot of money to have a DJ get that record in the top 40, pay that record pay that radio station off. They call it top 40 because they only play 40 records. They play 40 records all day long.
Over,
they say Corey
again.
Was at E2 nightclub in Chicago. That is my time. That's my time. Mm-hmm. E2.
Yeah.
No, but I'm saying music wise, you choose what you're feeling, the vibe and the mood.
But
you know what
but
I'm
see
saying?
These, like, the business of music is different. This is not the time where I was just telling somebody this the other day. When you hear Billie Jean by Michael Jackson, you know right off the top That's a bona fide hit record. Period. Mm-hmm. Period. Michael didn't. Them niggas didn't have to go pay DJs to spin that. That shit was fire. They didn't need DJs to spin that. Mm-hmm. When you gotta pay DJs, Jay-Z, I gotta pay DJs to spin my records. Mm-hmm. That means they not automatically hits. But if I play that shit 785,000 times, if I get BDS behind it and I'm counting spins and I'm paying for spins, you're going to get programmed with the sound. Mm-hmm. The sound is going to be programmed into you.
Right.
Listen, no disrespect to Master P, probably one of the most brilliant marketers and entrepreneurs in music industry history, in the history of business. Mm-hmm. But that music was garbage. I'm talking about just the quality of it. I'm talking about, like, when you listening to hip hop, like, no disrespect.
Not all of it.
Man.
Not all of it.
I had to hear that shit for years in order for something to stick.
I think what it is.
It wasn't good.
No Limit had cuts out. You can't deny that. But what it is, it became.
But that's the only part.
The business. Where I gotta put this shit out. I gotta have this shit coming in. Mm. I mean, that's cause crazy. Think about it. You know, I can name some cuts Master P had, cause he never got credit for a rapper. But he had some
what was that one record?
I call
it Nah.
That was a cut.
Nah,
I fuck with that one.
Nigga, I'm the colonel of this motherfucking take. Get the fuck out of here.
I'm the colonel.
I'll rap on my nigga. I'll die on my nigga.
I wasn't fucking with that either. What? But I tell you what.
Hold on. Are you gonna say
I'm Mystical sitting here?
Was it?
Oh, Mystical was dope.
Mystical's dope.
That's that part. Yeah.
Sound a lot of matter. Yo, first off, check this out. I came in with my dick in my hand.
Hold on.
I can't hit with your ass.
This is what I want everybody to know. I brought up Mystical for a reason.
Mystical was dope now.
They can't get rid of Mystical as easy as they can get rid of the others because he stands out. He brought something different.
Mystical was dope.
Jackson brought something different. So what I'm trying to say is when motherfuckers send music out in the world, I can't believe how much pride they have in shit that has no originality to it. You basically sampled a beat from a song that already wasn't shit and made it even worse. Mm. But you'll be like, listen to my shit. And I'm telling you, that's not true with all motherfuckers.
But I just think,
when you press that shit, you'll be like, okay, he different.
But I just think, I think behind the scenes,
Kendrick Lamar's way different.
He's dope.
Yeah.
He got a mind.
You're right.
He stands out.
But I think
you want to play some of this shit that they bumping on the radio?
Oh, my Lord.
But see, that's what I'm saying. I think behind the scenes, this is one of the main reasons why I got out of the industry, because there was a push for a certain type of sound.
It's just the sound.
There was a push. Like, when you... First off, go back and listen to Public Enemy's most significant album. It takes a nation of millions to hold us back. The title alone. Mm-hmm. It takes a nation of millions to hold us back. Mm-hmm. Public Enemy. Who's Public Enemy? Oh, Public Enemy number one is the black man. It takes a nation of millions to hold us back.
Oh.
Well, we're going to need the polar opposite of that shit. Mm-hmm. Quick.
That's what happened, because I'm telling you, man.
And it won't last. You got to keep coming with groups. Right.
Darlene, do you remember when the lynch mob, Freedom got an AK?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The video where they got the pistol holding it up to Lincoln head in the video.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm getting all you motherfuckers back.
Mm-hmm.
They put an end to all that shit.
All
and
that.
Now,
all that.
I want you to play. Mm-hmm. The top 10 rap songs this year. Just play them back and you tell me. You play the top 10 rap songs from that year Public Enemy came out.
God damn.
And I want you to, I'm not talking about what song sounded better. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about the content of each song. I think the artists today would be ashamed of what they're allowed to put on. They might catch on and say,
that's what I'm saying. What?
The reason we make music like this, because if we make music that's deep, it don't get spins.
They don't make money.
At
I already
one
know.
Time, people were saying that, but now people are justifying music
mm-hmm.
that is basically saying nothing. I can make a cut with a phrase.
Shabba ranks.
A drop of butter was clean to me.
But here's the thing. You can't play any of the songs now. You can't say, hey, in 5 years, are you going to want to play that? 10 years, 20 years. Hell no. What happened to a song 2 years ago? What was it?
Somebody say Ice-T started the crime rhyme.
Well, yeah.
No, I don't think he started it. I don't think it was. Ice-T is before. Ice-T is before.
They weren't out.
But then you got Toddy T.
I'm not taking that away from Ice-T. Look, Ice-T, I used to call him one of the best lyricists in the game because I remember when he was on Breaking. That's when I saw Ice-T.
Reckless.
Like, oh, who is this? It's the white girl. She's flipping, she's swinging, she's dancing it out.
But
she's
they heard him. But they heard him in Good Friends. He was in the hood when they got him. They said, hey, oh, that's cool. You could do that. Here, we're going to pay you 40 G's one time just to do this way. Okay, cool. Let's do that. And then that's what got him out of that. You know what I'm saying? But
see, that's something I don't know. He was before exactly. NWA. Wait,
yeah, he was.
Really, some of them
and
weren't even
born. Just Ice was too. Yes, I am.
Schoolie D was
just Ice.
Schoolie D came just right after
Ice
that, around
was,
that.
Was gangstering it
that's
up.
That's our homeboy. Yeah. He lives out here now.
Yeah. Uh huh. I gotta meet that dude.
Yeah,
that's
just Ice, guy. Legendary.
You don't know Just Ice.
Put that record back on.
Tell me you don't. Don't tell sick. Me you know hip hop. Yeah. I'm sorry.
But that's, I'm just saying you can listen to that stuff still now. Right now the songs
that
come out.
All of that.
I ask even my son admits it. He goes, "No, you're right." Like he'll be like, "Yeah, I like it right now. It's cool. It's good for the vibe. Mm-hmm. The whole party scene that let's get partying. Let's do as they turn it up." But after that it's
But music is part of the ritual. Right. Music is part of the dating ritual. Music is part of the conversation that happens in a community. Music is the soundtrack to everybody's life. So tell me it's not genius for the music industry to say, if we're in business with private prisons, we've got to change the ritual that the music is saying. If the ritual of the music is saying, I respect this woman, I want to date this woman, I want to marry this woman, we got
to
change that. So, but listen to this one second.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Public Enemy was the first time a lot of motherfuckers heard Farrakhan's voice. And it was put in some of the best musical hip-hop production anybody had ever heard.
Farrakhan's a prophet, and I think you ought to listen to what he can say to you.
So listen,
what
are
you going to do?
Follow for now.
This is what I want to say, because a lot of the viewers on this show are not hip on what we're saying.
Right, they get
so,
jipped.
So listen, you said a guy that people are like, it's people up there saying, I never heard of none of these guys.
Well, good, they can
so
check
listen,
it out.
So listen, that's what I'm saying. If you was to tell somebody a rapper they never heard of, to get on their thing and Google and listen to their shit.
Dope.
Who would you say?
Oh, man.
I would say, listen, you got to go listen to KRS-One.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
KRS-One. So, youngsters, y'all listen to KRS-One.
The original Blueprint.
Wait, which album?
The Blueprint.
The nigga got the Blueprint.
KRS-One came up with the Blueprint before Jay
one.
And all
that's
of
true.
Them.
Right. They yeah. don't know that. They think
they
Jay is the Blueprint.
That, nah. KRS-One is the first
like
rapper
to
have an album.
Yeah.
Blueprint. I went to go see Boosie Collins.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I found out a lot of the rappers were influenced by Boosie Collins.
No question. Yeah.
So, all you youngsters out there, Boosie Collins is a little, he's before my time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But this shit you doing ain't new. So, KIS-One, who would you say?
Man, it's shit. He took.
I always tell people.
What do you think?
Lynch Mob, Gorillaz in the Mist. Mm-hmm.
That Lynch Mob, Gorillaz in
the
Mist.
It's hard to find because there's a lot of groups that call themselves the Lynch Mob.
Right.
But I'm talking about the Lynch Mob,
one.
Gorillaz in the Mist. The first song, the first two songs. Man, I want you to listen to this.
Listen to this record. This one record.
I'll tell you, when that album came out, this is when albums was a bit, your artwork on your album was just as important.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
When you looked at the front of it, it was niggas thugged out, white tees, Chucks, Dickies, bass, you know, golf hats, gloves. And
you're talking about the Lynch Mob, Gorillaz in the Mist.
Right. And then when you opened up the album, you had all of those dudes on one side, and then on the other side was the whole Fruits of Islam.
Yes, I remember that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was like, whoa, hold on.
Gorillaz in the Mist. 1992 is when this came out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All I want you to do, youngsters, find a way to listen to the first two songs. It talk about capital punishment in America. Mm-hmm. That's not a song. That's just dropping knowledge on how America get out. And then the number two song is Buck the Devil.
Wow. Buck the Devil. I would suggest you get that first X-Clan album.
Grand Verbalizer, what time is it?
Right? I'm going to tell you right now, get Kumo D's Knowledge is King album.
Hey, hey, let me tell you something. That is wrong. You talking about a lyricist? I used to say Ice-T and motherfucker Kumo D lyrically are killer, even though LL Cool J made some good songs.
Yes. He was a song builder.
He was dope. I remember when LL had the impact that 50 Cent had.
Same level, kind of like you that. You understand? Yeah.
When Thugs was like, just yo, LL, and this is before Mama said knock you out. When L first came out.
As a youngster.
My radio? And you know, I can't live without my radio. Yeah. What?
In a lot of ways, Mo made LL what he is. People don't understand their relationship.
I will say this about that. I was always on Kool Moe Dee's side of the game.
Oh, yeah.
Because I felt like lyrically he destroyed LL.
With that, what was the name of that record? Let's Go. Let's Go.
Yeah.
Let's Go.
The one with all the L's.
Right.
When he lower, level, lousy. Oh, he destroyed that nigga. That, yikes. And at that time, I was an LL fan. Yeah, I wasn't even fucking with him.
I remember that.
But when that motherfucker dropped Let's Go, I knew. Like, it's over.
Who was the better rapper, but LL had that appeal where...
He was for us. He was young. He was for us.
He was a young teenager. L is our age.
Mo is older. So he's like, shut your old ass up. Kind of like what they say.
I know why you like LL.
Here we go.
But I'm just saying.
Why I like LL.
He always wore his hat.
I knew it.
LL never took that hat off.
When he came to World on Wheels, his first performance at World on Wheels, he wore a red fuzzy Kango and the Crips.
I already got beat up.
Ran him out of there. Right, we have pictures of him. They ran him out of there.
KRS-One, Ghetto Music, The Blueprint, 1988-89. On the cover of his album, he's sitting down and a cop is standing up, is standing over him with the Billy Club. Behind his back.
That
Blueprint album.
Right now.
First off, that album, You Must Learn.
Oh, yeah.
Remember the record, You Must Learn? No, My Philosophy is a different album. From the Blueprint, You Must Learn was on there. And remember the record, Why Is That?
Where this nigga
literally broke down the ethnic genealogy of the Bible.
Hold on.
Why is that?
What Joe just said right there is also a song that I think all you youngsters should just really Google and listen to. Why is that?
Why is that? It's really deep.
And this is what I want to say. That's another album. What I want to say, listen.
Dope album.
I'm not, maybe I need to retract. Mm-hmm. I'm not here to diss new artists.
Right.
That's not what I'm trying to do.
We had versions of that, though. See, let's not forget. We had our own versions of that type of music.
PM
we had
Dawn.
Choices. Egyptian Lover, which I love, stuff like that. We had choices of either you could go deep, do you know what I'm saying? Or you can go the kind of like pop and kind of fun, clubby stuff. We had those options.
I'm not trying to diss new rappers. I apologize if I came off that way because that's not the point I'm trying to make. The point I'm trying to make is Viacom has brainwashed you into making music that they're willing to play.
And thinking you
have to
make
music. That's all
I'm
trying
to
say.
Right.
Now, Darlene, what's a group that we might not be saying that you know? Because, Darlene, you know a lot about this shit to be a girl.
She was there.
I mean, she was there. Raz, Kelly.
Darlene tried to fight Kelly in Breaking 2. She was in the back with that group of girls. Oh, who was after.
Special K.
Actually, that's the interesting thing.
Special K. Right.
The interesting thing about it is even the way people treated each other, though, back in those days, that was different. Because I never even had beef with anybody. anybody.
That's the point I'm trying to make.
That's what I'm saying. So we
the music
all
influences how we treat each other.
Wow. That's true.
A West Coast girl, you know, all about bathing suits, California, different type of look, could go to the East Coast, and then they you would get a look like, what the hell does she have on? And I'm looking at them, New York girls, but then they're like, you're curious. So instead of dissing one another, we would just like, what's up with that? You know what I'm saying? Next thing you know, you're kind of building and you figuring things out. But nowadays.
So look what happens in our community. When you see, first off, the Rolling Stones are like rolling dinosaurs. But the white community who love Rolling Stones keep them alive. Those guys tour every year. They support them. They induct them into Hall of Fames. They do all types of shit, right? What's the other group? The Grateful Dead, right?
These motherfuckers. The Solo Beatles.
Right. These guys, Led Zeppelin, the Eagles. They keep their shit alive.
Everybody.
Right. What happens? What happens with our shit? Oh, that shit is old. I don't listen to that anymore. If you look at Mike,
because it's not standing the test of time. It's not priceless music. It's not music that's built to be something that you can listen to.
Right. Ooh.
5 years later.
That's what
10
I'm saying.
10 years later.
That, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what they say?
Compared to
yeah, let's go into
well,
that.
I don't know if it's not something.
By me being on Wildin' Out,
there
are rappers that did Wildin' Out just 5 years ago.
And now?
Who are not only not relevant now.
They're
not relevant now. They're doing nothing now. Because when they were hot, you were a trend that only lasted 2 years.
But why is that? My question is the trend mentality something that is imposed on us, or is it something we're imposing on ourselves? Because what I used to work for Madonna. To see Madonna tongue kissing Drake, I'm saying, how is Madonna still here?
Wait, fuck that. You said you used to work for Madonna?
Yeah, he
was
at Maverick.
I was at Maverick Records as a senior VP of Black Music A&R.
Did you get a chance?
Oh God, that I knew he was going. You know what?
I got.
Did you ever have like a box?
No, but I got a terrible story.
You don't have to Maverick.
Yes.
Okay.
But you can listen.
Shut the fuck up,
nigga. You can listen to her music from here on out.
But my point is, she gets to keep reenacting shit. Okay. She came out in the 90s or in the early 2000s and kissed Britney in the mouth. Then she comes back, kissed Britney and Christina. Then she comes back, kissed Drake. It's like she gets to keep reenacting her fucking ritual. And she still, what record has she come out in the last 10 years that anybody gives a fuck about?
That's true, nothing. They just want her old
but
stuff.
But she's a symbol, and they keep their symbols alive. It's niggas running around talking about our music ain't relevant. Mm-hmm. It's us. I never hear white people say. What I hear is, if you go to fucking Europe,
everybody can go to Europe.
Them motherfuckers love hip hop.
Everything.
They love hip hop.
That's right.
Amsterdam.
You're right.
Finland.
They fuck with hip hop.
They bump everything.
They love it. All of it. It's alive over there. Motherfuckers is breakdancing, popping.
They've been.
They listening to Run-DMC, Kumo D, KRS, all that shit. They listening to everything.
They get into it deeper and they respect it.
So that's how come I say that our thing is strategically, you got to understand, the black community in this country is the buyers. And that's it.
That's it.
We want
niggers.
You to buy what we want you to, what we're going to sell to you, and you buy it, and we keep it fresh and keep it new so that you keep rebuying shit. How many times have gold chains been in style and then out of style and then in style and then out of style? When I was coming up, Dookie Ropes was it. Oh, look at this.
That nigga's Dookie.
Dookie Ropes. And then it went, oh my gosh, this nigga has Cuban links. And then it's platinum. Every year is something else because they used you to sell to, and that's it. You have to understand that you got value.
Right.
If you don't pick it up and value it, nobody else is.
Right.
Once
a
you
new
pick
kid.
It up and value it, now you got the key, baby. You got the juice.
There's a new kid out there that I like. that's saying something. Of course, I like Kendrick. I like J. Cole. I like Big Crit. That kid. Mm-hmm. It's a couple of kids out there that are saying something, and I think this era is starting to come back.
Yeah.
You know, especially with Kendrick. This, because when we did that the nigga show where we broke down the history of the word. Mm-hmm. Kendrick's album dropped the same day, and he has the Negus Negus term in his album, and a lot of kids was hitting me saying, what the fuck is that? Oh, Zoe Show, explain that shit. Mm-hmm. So there's a conscious movement happening again, but I'm telling you, when you change the music, you change the relating. You change the relating. If the music has anger, fear, angst, competition, enmity, hatred.
Truffle butter.
Right. If it's got all that bullshit in it, our relationship is going to be disjointed. Mm-hmm. Because that rhythm, no matter what, that beat is hypnotic. And I hear people say, oh, I just like the beat. I don't listen to the words. Are you out your fucking mind? Your subconscious records everything. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Keep the hairs ringing. Mm-hmm. Ding, mm-hmm. Ding. Mm-hmm.
The Ice Age of hip hop is slowly starting to end.
Slowly kind of coming around. Wow. Some kids are finally getting it. It doesn't have to be, it doesn't have to be so heavy where, oh God, they're giving us these messages. No, that was the whole point of it, was that you had a message in a song, but it wasn't like, oh, they're preaching. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that was the whole meaning of it, was that it was like,
shit, Chuck D was preaching, goddammit.
No, I know, but he did it in a way where you wanted to listen to it. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like, oh, I don't want to hear it.
KRS-One was preaching.
There you go.
He did it in a way you wanted to hear it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But don't lose sight of who is the perpetrator of making the artist feel like they have to conform
exactly
to what the man won't.
Mm. Exactly. Mm-hmm. But that's what it is.
That's what it is, right.
That's what I'm trying to say,
right.
Though.
That's the gist.
Biggie, listen, Biggie was a big part of it. Biggie was, you know.
Who was pushing him out?
Let me tell you something, man. Puffy, let me tell you something, man.
A perpetrator. Bullshit.
Melly Mel. You guys remember Melly Mel? Grandmaster Flash, Melly Mel? That motherfucker said Biggie Smalls was the dopest rapper to have never said nothing.
That's real.
Now, that's the realest shit I've ever heard. Right. Because what he was saying was that nigga was so dope, but he wasn't talking about shit. But he brought in the swag, the money, and then Jay-Z took that blueprint.
Black, ugly as ever, however. Gucci
down to the socks.
I get it.
That motherfucker was incredible.
But that's that, in my opinion, that's that Puffy influence.
Right? Yeah. Right? That's that Manhattan.
Every motherfucker I know uptown, baby, who fuck with Puffy popped off. I'm here to tell you. I see these niggas. I never say names, but I meet these niggas, and they all got the same story about that motherfucker.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm putting it out there. What the fuck?
So the hip-hop artist is responsible
for
putting the code of ethics for the new generation in place.
I agree.
All I'm going to say is
go ahead.
Listen, man. Like my man Tyler, the Creator, Cherry Bomb. Mm-hmm. And people can say, you can say whatever you want to say about it, but he's sticking by his guns. He didn't care if I like it, if you like it. He likes it.
Mm. Right.
Do what you like. Don't do what the industry tells you you should do. Mm-hmm. And this is what the people are going to like. No. Do what you like.
They get influenced by that money. They'll throw in a couple of...
But see, this is why...
Freeze Love, if you don't do what you like, then your career is basically in the hands of the motherfucker that ain't gonna never give you shit. But if you do what you like and the people like it, you can eat. Mm-hmm. It's just it don't come fast.
Right.
Motherfuckers gotta catch on to you.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That's real.
Do you guys remember a couple of years ago? That just popped into my head. I don't know why, but when because now in hindsight you look back and you're like, oh my God, why were those people getting all mad trying to stand up for Soulja Boy when my ex said something in an interview. I don't know if you recall that when it happened. Remember that?
And he was Soulja Boy, Superman. That hoe.
He was like, "Oh, he's killing rap. He's murdering it." Right?
I remember that.
And everybody got, "Oh, Soulja Boy."
No, I remember. I remember Ice.
And two people came to say, "Now we're there. We want to go." Okay, who was it?
I remember Ice. 50 Cent
and Nelly or somebody like that was like, "Oh, Ice-T, he's just mad. He just didn't want to, you know, he shouldn't be saying this." Well, okay.
No,
well,
I remember Ice. I remember that. I remember that.
When that happened, and all he said was,
"Man, I mean, because just think about it. The biggest record the young brother had, and no disrespect to the young brother, to go back to my Master P point. Master P was, like I said, one of the most incredible businessmen we've ever seen in our lives. That's how savvy this dude was. I didn't particularly like his music, but he was able to build an empire, spread that shit out, and then matriculate from hip-hop into other things. Mm-hmm. But when Ice went at Soulja Boy, I was with Ice on it because I understood what Ice is saying.
Yeah, that's
he was just
meant.
Talking about the quality of the MC.
It was starting at
now,
the where the song.
There's a record that came out. What's the Bobby Shmurda? My 18-year-old loves that shit. That what's the name of that Hot Boy record? Hot nigga, whatever. Man, that shit don't sound like New York. Like, there's New York legendary hip-hop niggas that are like, "Wow, that's from here? That's us?" Mm-hmm. He one of us. But the level of it has eroded.
What is he rapping about?
I don't know what the fuck. I listened to it.
See, that's another thing. Hip-hop region used to play a big part in it because it wasn't videos.
Right.
Now, everything is connected. There's no difference between an L.A. artist and a New York artist and a down
Midwest,
south artist.
Yeah.
Midwest, Canada, wherever. As long as it's just that
long
artist,
as truffle
that
butter
cutter,
is involved.
There it is. Rub some truffle
it out.
Butter on yourself and get out there and rap, kid.
You've got the stuff.
You're it.
Well, look, this is what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I'm saying this. This is another thing that nobody else has said. The people who are getting opportunities are the people who fucking each other in the ass.
Uh-oh.
Nobody wants to say that, but the people who are finding ways to get record play are the homosexual men. And I don't think that's fair. Because, you know what I'm saying? It's like, we need heterosexual-minded rappers instead of homosexual-minded rappers acting heterosexual. Because that is showing in the music.
So you see the big war, right, that's going on. There's a couple of wars on the hip-hop front. Baby and Lil Wayne warn. Mm-hmm. And then what's the dude that's supposed to be replacing Lil Wayne? Young Thug, I guess, is gay, I guess. And it's
you
like.
Guess? Why do you guess?
Well, because I don't know the nigga. And that's just. What is he? He calls Baby his hubby?
First off.
So why does he call Baby his hubby?
Wow.
Why are you surprised? His name is Baby. Back in the day, real men, they didn't play with him.
Wow.
So what is Lil Wayne? What is Lil Wayne? This is what I was saying to Lil Wayne. Lil Wayne, what do you think you're doing by abandoning the camp after all these years?
Well, I think it's a money issue.
For sure.
I think he feels like he got jerked out of some bread, and he wants his bread. He wants control of his acts that he brought through, which is Drake and Nicki Minaj. Mm-hmm. So, again, I don't know all the details. What I do know is the motherfucker Baby came out and said Drake was Lil Wayne was gay, and that some of those raps that he had or records that he made were about Drake. I'm like, man, this is this is some shit, man, where hip hop is unrecognizable. Mm-hmm.
If you know anything about the industry, meaning like you've been around this shit, you know that most of the guys who rap on Viacom who got opportunities have gay roots. They were around gay people. I'm talking about the rappers.
Wow.
It's like
gay roots. What is a gay root?
They come from a gay motherfucker put you out
planted
there.
Planted in truffle butter. So
right. The roots is the shit up under you. Just like Eddie Long, T.D. Jakes brought him into the game. So what did that tell you? But them I just, Bible studies stunk.
I think people are going to get more desperate to be put out. Wait, look, because they're not selling nowadays. So I think
it's
a lot of
stunk in Bible study. Desperate.
They think that just by like being seen, that's what they want. They're taking fame over anything else because they're not selling. Records aren't selling nowadays unless you're like somebody big. You come out huge. But they're not selling.
Corey just touched on something huge.
They think that they're not.
Corey just touched on something, man.
As you see, they don't last. Where's the money? Where's your backup? Where's property? Where's this? They're gone.
Somebody said Baby and Lil Wayne broke the oath amongst each other.
Wow.
You never hear these guys calling each other homosexuals, but we know where they come from and how they get out.
Wow.
So they broke the oath.
You just touched on something gigantic. What happened with Sugar Ray Leonard?
You tell me.
Anybody read Sugar Ray Leonard's book?
No.
Was it new?
He talks about how he was, after he won the gold medal, right? Mm-hmm. And how he was transitioning to pro. In his book, he talks about how his Olympic coach in the limousine forced him to suck his dick.
What?
You know, he came out.
Wait.
Sugar Ray Leonard.
Sugar Ray Leonard said, my coach made me suck his dick.
Yes, that's right. Now, look at Corey's face. So what?
Sugar Ray Leonard, couldn't you whoop your coach's ass?
Whoop that motherfucker's ass. And then on top of that.
That's why I was finna go. I was trying to hold it.
But then on top of that.
Gonna say.
But then, what I'm saying is, it seems like every time there's some type of handler or the bridge to your success, especially a fluffer in this case, to some type of that's Young Thug. Yeah,
get the fuck out of here. That's the nigga, man.
Yeah.
Oh my fucking god, is that fucking real?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are you fucking kidding me, man? Nope. Do you have to see more?
Right. No. So anybody who wants to know about the Sugar Ray story, you just get his book. He tells this story in his book. He talks about how, he was forced to suck this dude's dick. But my question is, just like you said, nigga, you Sugar Ray Leonard, you could whoop his ass. And then if you did it any times after that, you wanted to do it.
I hate when motherfuckers act like they was forced. What was them motherfuckers, B2K motherfuckers?
You were in prison. This ain't American Me. You know
he made me do it. I don't like them niggas.
Yeah,
this motherfucker made you do it.
For fame once again. Hey, and where
there wasn't no blood or nothing involved in this shit.
Right, no court cases, no
they
police.
They were holding a family hostage.
No dick bit off.
Right. No, holding a family hostage, huh?
What people do for money. Remember that song?
Yeah. I think.
There it is.
What people do.
For money.
So that's Young Thug, huh?
Wow.
That's Young Thug. I never saw him. I heard of him, of course.
Where is he? Young Thug. He's Thug. Thug. Where's his dude? Thug at?
Where's the Thug portion?
He's shopping thug at the mall. He's a
his
Thug
name,
in the mall.
Thug is on the race, bro, David.
His name should be Hole Plugged.
Wow.
That's here not Young.
MC Hole Plugger.
You know
I'm
what?
Packing him.
I be getting my whole plug every night. My whole plug to the Sugar White.
What?
What?
That's what I'm saying.
That's his song. Anyway. That's his song.
Don't no motherfuckers play like that, man. Who ain't?
Oh, no.
That's B2K, guys.
Come on, my nigga. Anytime.
You know what?
Anytime, yo, man, get them niggas' feet out my face. Man. First of all, nigga, I don't play that shit. Don't twinkle your toes in front of me.
Yeah.
Get them niggas' feet out my face.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Where are the real men at?
Wow.
Where's the real?
What about all the mother skirt wearers?
For that fame, the performers, entertainers.
I ain't gonna lie, man. Once I got out here and I saw how these niggas get out, man, I was demoralized. I was like, man, I ain't gonna never make it, man.
The truffle plugger.
You mean in Hollywood?
Yeah, when I got to Hollywood and I saw how many homosexuals are in charge. The gatekeeper motherfuckers. Them motherfuckers.
The naysayers. The gatekeepers.
The eyes buck niggas.
The whistleblowers. Those dudes.
The motherfuckers blowing shit.
Oh, you want to come to this party, do you?
They'll let you come to the party. I done been invited to them shits.
I've been to a gang of parties, but it's you gotta leave and the party.
They don't force
it's
nothing on you like that.
Don't leave the party. It's when you say, hey, man, let's go, we going to another party. What you mean you staying
here? Oh, you want to go to another party?
Why are you staying here? Oh.
Right. It's just like the devil's advocate. Motherfucker like, I didn't make you do this shit. Right. You did this shit.
Right.
You know what I think? I think Marianne is going to... You know what motherfucker said? That shit, I was dying. Oh, the devil's advocate. That movie.
Oh, yeah.
This motherfucker, that's what you did. I don't make you. He said, I don't do that. You did it because you wanted to do it.
Motherfuckers. So, well, that's a great movie.
Yeah.
So you think if they give it, the kids will switch over. So if there's somebody that comes out, like if we keep getting some Kendricks, we keep getting some J. Coles, we
Here's
keep
the
them
thing,
in,
though,
I think they'll actually...
If you get anything through the system, right, there's always going to be a catch.
Yeah.
And speaking of truffle butter, this is why I admire Tyler Perry. Because at least Tyler Perry... is he don't have to depend on the system at all. That motherfucker got his own goddamn studio. He could film his shit, package his shit, deliver his shit. What? That's his shit.
Wait, let me speak to that. When they see you can sell shit, the system comes to you.
You see how they dropped him?
On the system, though. You probably ain't shit.
You ain't shit.
But when the system is saying, hey, what's up?
Look, can we do business?
That means you own the something.
You already baked your pie, and they knocking on your door asking for a slice of it. But if you come to them with just the ingredients and this shit ain't cooked, they not fucking with you. Everybody got ingredients to make a pie.
And I'm going to tell you, that's how they eat. That's how the truffle butters eat. Because they know that you want to get on the bandwagon. So listen, when you come to Hollywood, you better have your own bandwagon. Roll into this motherfucker on your own bandwagon. Mm-hmm. Don't come here asking somebody to
build
you a bandwagon.
Word.
We'll build you a bandwagon.
Have your ground stand.
And load it up with truffle butter.
Because guess
if
what?
If you're willing to put dick on your tonsils,
here we go.
Come get it. It's here for you. You can make it fast.
You know what? Niggas think that the fucking casting couch hasn't always been here. It's always been here. But the problem is, it wasn't a climate for gayety to be out. It was always there, but it was heterosexual. It made you think, oh, it's just for women to come. Dude, that goddamn couch has been here, and it's been a two-way street for many, many years. Yeah. Don't get it twisted. I used to always feel strange when I was at fucking Maverick, and it was racism there, too.
Oh, racism is
racist. It was racist. Hey, hand this. They brought this tape to the wrong person. Give it to the black A&R. I said, is that the person who runs black music, which is me? Black music A&R? Or the black A&R because I'm black? Like,
they're
what are you
the same? What like you don't know.
Give it to the guy with the hat on. How about that? Does that make you feel better?
Right. Like, what does that mean? Right. Or I felt uncomfortable. I came in there with, you know, remember the Jazzy Fat Nasties? I was trying to sign them. I came in there with this girl group, beautiful girl group, trying to sign them. Nigga, I bring the music in there. And I was always uncomfortable. Freddie DeMann used to be Michael Jackson.
Ooh, yeah, I know.
Michael Jackson's manager, Madonna's manager, Lionel Richie's manager. What's the other girl? Macy Gray's manager. I brought him this music. He's like, oh, yeah, that music is great. It makes my dick hard. I'd be like, who talks like this?
Wait, so a nigga said that to you something make your dick hard?
Play the music. You got some music for us? I was like, yeah, listen to this. I want to sign these girls.
That's why I know I don't even fit in out here.
Oh, wow, that's incredible. That shit makes my dick hard.
When the white motherfuckers be like, that makes my dick hard. They he coming at you. I'll be like, hold up, man. What you on? But anyway,
exactly.
This is that industry, man.
Check it out. I just think that a lot of the youngsters, we're not dissing like you said. Go ahead. But check it out. Nowadays they got Google. You can go back and you can YouTube And you can find something that you'd be like, damn,
I'm
feeling
that. You'd be surprised how many people will look at this shit because we said it. And they'll be like, man, you put me up on something. Right. Remember, if you got time, Boosie Collins is way before your time. Mm-hmm. But if you listen to what he did, you will see, oh, this is what them motherfuckers
shit,
be
even
doing.
James Brown, all of them. Yeah.
You got to remember, Afrika Bambaataa.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Godfather hip hop. Mm-hmm.
Shit.
Really, Afrika Bambaataa, Kool Herc, and the Burning Spear. Afrika Bambaataa started off trying to make a funk group. As Parliament Funkadelic, as Bootsy Collins. Funk was the music of the people in between R&B and hip hop.
Right.
It wasn't just R&B, and then along came hip hop.
Getting
no,
down just funk. For the fuck.
Knee deep.
Bootsy Collins.
Feet don't fail me not.
Hey, come on. They was killing it. Still, and you can put it on right now, and it'll still
and
knock.
Still,
and them niggas was on that truffle butter
you
shit.
Know
but
what?
Look here. What we gonna do right now? We got to rap, according to Chris. We you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't had no sleep. I'm beat to the motherfucker. But listen, Richmond, Virginia, I'll be out there this week. I want y'all to come out to the little pussy ass club and let me witness me do my thing. I would appreciate it because I ain't been to Richmond in a minute. But last time I was there, I did this theater and. I'm just saying, the comedy club is going to be one of them weeks.
No videotaping.
No videotaping.
No videotaping.
You got the Funny Bone?
Yeah, the Funny Bone in Richmond. They got some NASCAR event going down there, so hotel's a motherfucker. But all the people in Richmond, come fuck with your boy. What's going on with you, Mr. Freeze
you know, this
Love?
This weekend, I'm
going
to be somewhere here in L.A., lighting up a stage. Maybe to the J Spot. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I might be just mowing my motherfucking lawn and smoking a blunt.
Uh-oh.
Enjoying being in L.A.
Come to the Dragonfly. Go to the day party. It's the best.
A day party?
Yeah, it's old school. They play old school R&B and hip-hop.
Maybe me and my wife might.
Ooh, she would like that. I'm telling you.
Miles.
I'm dancing from 2 to 8.
Darlene going to be in there with a Last Dragon t-shirt on.
Ty Mac.
Show no.
Kiss my convert.
Yeah.
So what's happening with
you? Yo, you guys can catch us tomorrow night on Dash Radio. Of course, you got to get the Dash Radio app on, you know, your iPhone or your Android, your Google Plus, whatever. Download the app. We're on a station on there called Hot Button Radio. And, man, it's going to be crazy. From 5 to 7 p.m., The Voice of Reason on Hot Button Radio Dash Radio. Do it now.
Nice.
Hey, so check this out. D, what's cracking with you this weekend?
I'm going to go to my friend's party and support that. Might
which
go up the day party.
The day party? Where?
Yeah. At Dragonfly. Hey, Quee. What's up, Quee? And then some good-looking fellas. No, those are some real men, ladies.
It's in Hollywood.
Oh, stop. Not everybody in Hollywood now, Corey, is...
But I just asked you a question.
Yes, it's in
Truffle Butter Pot.
No, but
look
they...
here.
Oh, my God.
Real talk. To get plugged on the show, for all those who are watching this on YouTube...
Oh, Lord.
Zoe Chris. Beefing with SeaWorld Dolphins. These niggas are talking about my head.
Hey, Chris, so they go to Ustream 150 show... And they'll eventually find what's cracking. Because my homeboy Scope Bubba found his way to get, what do they have to do?
If they want to sign into the chat room, they just, they can sign through Facebook.
If you want to sign into the chat room, you can sign in through Facebook or Twitter.
Yeah.
But do you have to be, what's the shit, you have to join something?
No, you don't.
You don't?
Just sign in on, sign in Ustream through your Facebook and Twitter, that's it.
Sign in Ustream through your Facebook and Twitter. And, you know, be part of the chat room, man. All our chat room dudes, they be going in. They said, Freeze Love look like Fat Joe, little brother. Corey equal big.
They said I use truffle butter on my edges, on my baby hairs.
Chris has sauna breath.
Bring it.
Nah, ain't no good ones today. Y'all normally great.
Yo, I was in Miami one time, and there was a bunch of kids riding a bike. And they looked at me. I was with my wife. And they looked at me and they said, look, it's Fat Joe. Fat Joe.